Hello everyone! Welcome back to more Explorers of Sky, where I am fucking terrified. Things I have noticed in the opening movie. Grovyle with party members on Lapras is back. Okay, I hate that, because I think I know what that means. And also, Dialga's in the opening, and given time's all fucked up, I'm not happy. I've got so many fucking ideas. But today, I think it is time we get on with what is apparently a pretty big moment in the story. Hello everyone, let's begin. Alright then, and anyone who wishes to be in the COCOM chat, just go ahead and set up the Discord call whenever. And let's begin. Ahem. About the attempt to capture Grovyle. We have yet to receive word that Grovyle has been captured. And we've got a call. Hello, Dakarilf. Welcome. How are you? I cannot hear you. I'm going to assume you're having mic issues.
Okay, I can hear you.
Oh, there you are. There you are.
Oh, okay. What just happened?
I don't know, but you're working now.
All right, cool.
Anyways, hi. Welcome.
Hi.
I understand that you are all itching for something to happen, but consider this a test of your patience, because we ask you to carry on with your usual work.
Was I wrong about this being...
You say that right as the siren starts. Oh, what's that siren? Deputy Magnemite is here. This is a message from Officer Magnazone. We are pleased to deliver this report. Grovyle has finally been captured. Whoa, at last!
God, I'm gonna be real. Like...
Yeah?
On one hand, I don't want to, like, stop you. But also, I want to tell you to wait a little bit so people can like...
We want to make sure people can filter in?
I think it'd probably be good because, like...
Alright.
Stuff happens quickly.
Alright, we'll give it a couple minutes, wait for people to show up. I think Jackie might be busy today... Or could be sleeping, because Jackie's been busy lately. Whisker Biscuit should be able to show up, but not in voice chat.
Yeah, I'm gonna...
Tactician Geek will be here in 8 minutes. I'm not gonna wait that long.
I'm gonna... Yeah, I have told a few other people.
Alright.
So I'm waiting to see if anybody's gonna show for a bit. Like, I don't know, maybe like 5 minutes or something.
We want to give it 5 minutes?
maybe five, maybe just like if we see people show up.
Yeah, let's go five or until people start showing up. In the meantime, how are you?
You know.
I do know.
Yeah, I am not gonna...
Yeah, no, it's fine.
Yeah, I'm not gonna... this on stream, but I have had stuff happening.
Yeah.
So.
God, I am so fucking excited. I only just noticed when I was booting up the stream today that Grovyle's with the party on Lapras's back in the opening movie. What the hell?
Mm-hmm.
I think I know what that means, too. I'm stressed. Things are about to happen, and I don't want them to, but also I want them to. Alright, I'm gonna be honest. I'm impatient. And there's Scrimbunkus. Hello.
They should add Perfect Cell to this game.
Let's just go ahead and go, and people will show up when they show up. By gosh, Grovyle's been caught. Oh my gosh, they did it. Yippee.
There's
more. Grovyle was captured by the Great Dust Noir. He has informed us that he will return to the future with Grovyle. Dust Noir is going home? Going back to the future? How do you go back? You wait, and it will eventually happen. I do not claim to understand the process, but I have heard they will be going through a tunnel. He called it a dimensional hole. He opened a dimensional hole in the town square, main square, I am told. Dust Noir told us that he wishes to say goodbye before he leaves. Therefore, he hopes that you'll come see him for the last time at Treasure Town Square. Hey, well, what are we doing here? Let's hurry, we have to go to Treasure Town. That is a hole indeed. Everyone's already here. Hey, I don't see the Great Dustmore around yet. No, don't call it that, please. I'm begging you. What's that? Quick, everyone, go through it. That is a dimensional hole. Dimensional hole? Oh, what Magnemite was trying to explain earlier. But golly, this is it? Isn't that something? So stepping inside this here thing will take you to the future. Watch out. Stay clear. The instant you touch it, you will be sent to the future. Please be extremely careful. Woof! Hey, Uxie, Mesprit, and Azelf too. Dekorilf. You're all safe. Am I glad to see that? Naturally. So was the plan successful? Yep. I have to hand it to the Great Dustmar. It was flawless. Grovyle's been captured. Uh-oh, did the stream freeze? I'm not seeing any issues on my end. I'm not seeing any network issues.
Stream looks fine to me.
I would refresh in that case. Scrimbungus, if you can hear me. Okay. Grovyle's been captured, and we regained all the time gears he's stolen. Yes, that's excellent. Dustmar should be along shortly. Oh, who's that? It's the Great Dustmar! Here comes the Great Dustmar! Everyone, make way! That's Grovyle? He looks like a bad guy, that's for sure. Heh, it's great they finally caught him. That's right, the world was nearly ruined because of him. Oh, he's muzzled too! Oh god!
Yeah. I would like to say, really quick, if you want to wait any more, like...
This is the last chance
last
to wait.
Last warning.
Okay. I'm going to ping a couple of people real quick. And then I'm just going to go for it. Okay, that should be about everyone. I think I should need to ping. So let's continue. Everyone, today I would like to share excellent news with you. Finally, Grovyle. Grovyle has been captured. Hello, Soul Foxy. Welcome to the stream.
Yeah, there we go. Hello, Soul.
This was all made possible by your selfless support and cooperation. I can't thank you enough. As you can see, Grovyle is a vicious and wicked Pokemon. His capture should result in lasting peace for your world. It looks like they have Grovyle muzzled. He can't say a word that way. But I must also deliver a sad piece of news. It is time for me to return to the future. Everyone, I must now bid you farewell. Oh, so that was true. Hey. But I'm feeling the blues. Hey, Whisker Biscuit. There was so much I wanted to learn from you, yup. Uxie, Mesprit, Azelf, I entrust you with the rest. Yep, we know. We've got the time gears back, and we'll make sure they return to their rightful places. The task is yours. Thank you very much for everything. You have literally saved us all. Oh, no. You have been most kind and helpful. I hope you'll continue to work to preserve the peace. Yes, you can depend on that. Now, I'm afraid the time has come. Well, that was a little mean. Didn't need to scratch as they went through. Everyone, though it pains me... Oogie, I hate sad goodbyes. I hope we see you again. Wah, Dustmar, sir! Oh, yes. Before I go, I must see two Pokemon. Dekorilf and Violet. That's us, let's go up there. So, this is really goodbye. Dustmar, sir, for everything you've done, thank you sincerely. Well, this is goodbye. Or is it? What? It's too soon for farewells. What?
Yeah, that is, yeah.
You two are coming with me. What? Yeah, that's about what I expected.
Yeah, I'm Jinx. That's me.
By gosh! Dekaril, Violet! We've been kidnapped! What just happened? What? What is this, Digimon World 3? Why is that what I think of? It more clearly resembles one of the Battle Network jack-in screens. Alright, we went down the hole. Now, what horrible things are we about to see? Where is this? I was...
Golem 3.
Dragged? I can't... Losing consciousness again. Ah, yes, we definitely saved the future. Definitely. Absolutely. Everything looks perfectly fine here. Not a single thing wrong with the future. Yep, saving the time gears. Absolutely. Oh my fucking god. Yes, I did remember it correctly. I am sorry to have kept you waiting, Master Dialga. While I encountered more difficulty than anticipated, I finally succeeded. In the capture, yes? I fully understand what must be done. Those who seek to alter the course of history must be removed from history. I'll see to the elimination immediately. I understand. As you wish. I take my leave. Alright, I think we can say how much I got spoiled on now. So, like, 10 years ago or so, when the game was still fairly new, I was interested in it, but not enough to pick it up, nor do I think I had the money to get it, to get a copy. So I did read a plot synopsis, like, 10 years ago, and very scant information remained in my brain. But what I did remember was, Dust Noir was evil, Grovyle was trying to stop this, and Dialga was the one responsible for time breaking, not the time gears. So I remember all of that, and it seems like we are now finally at that point.
Yeah, unfortunate that you remembered all that, because it would have been very funny to see it.
Yeah.
React to it. I mean, it's still funny.
It is still very good. And I feel like I would have started to get the idea that Dialga was involved because I did play Gen 4, and Dialga is in the opening movie, so like I feel like I would have put that together at some point. But still, hey,
and Time/Darkness and has the same plot as Sky. There's it's mainly just like quality of life changes. Well, there's some side content in Sky, but like the main story is the same.
Yeah. Hey, Violet! Wake up, Violet! Oh, we're in jail! Hooray! This is what we get for trusting the cops. The Time Cops! Where? You're awake! This place, I think it's a jail. Jail? I just woke up a while ago, so I'm not sure what's going on. I tried the doors, but they're locked, because it's jail. There seems to be no other way out. I think that we've been locked up. Actually, I'm curious about this as well.
Time and Darkness have a couple version-exclusive Pokemon between them and a couple version-exclusive items.
So it's standard Pokemon differences, then.
Yeah, like, there's very little that's different between... There's not much that's different between Time and Darkness. Sky has... is a massive difference between the two.
Got it. 7 copies. Amazing. What's going on? We're locked up? I don't know what's going on either, but I may as well investigate. But yeah, I think my memory is very, very, very hazy because, again, it was a long time ago. But I'm pretty sure the time I was interested in, like, looking up info about the games, it was before Sky came out. Like, roughly in that time period. I think it was announced, but not out yet. Oh, hey, we're on Xenoblade 3 Chapter 5, except not quite as traumatic. The doors fail to open. It's no good. Like Dakariel said, these doors won't open. No, just punch it repeatedly until your paws are bleeding. It sure looks like we've been locked up. How did we end up this way? I think what happened was, Dustmar grabbed us, then he dragged us into the dimensional hole. What? Wait, so is this maybe... is this the future? But that's... I can't believe this! I mean, this is the future? Why are we even here? But... this whole room is constructed in a way unlike anything I've ever seen. Now that I've had time to digest this, maybe this is actually the future. What, Violet? Did we really end up in the future? Now what should we do? So if this place is the future, how are we supposed to get back to our world? They're awake. How convenient. Alright, we'll do this quick. Do this quick? What? Do what? 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 They blindfolded me! I can't see a thing! Come with us. Ow, don't shove me! This blindfold makes it impossible to tell where I'm going. But where are they taking us? We're here. That is a lot of rope for a Shigs. My goodness. Where is this? They have me trussed up. I can't move. Why is this happening? That is a lot of rope. My god, they are not taking chances.
Yeah.
Hey. Tekorealf. Am I glad to see you? You're okay, right? You're clueless about what's going to happen. I guess you can afford to be nonchalant about it. Huh? That voice came from over there. Grovyle! I'm sorry, Nuzleaf! You two, do you have any inkling about where you are? No. This is a stockade. They're preparing to get rid of us for good. What? Get rid of us? Wait a second. It's easy to understand why they'd want to get rid of you, Nuzleaf. But why us? Oh, and for people who are new to the stream, the Nuzleaf joke, I literally mistook... I don't play a lot of Pokemon, so I literally mistook Grovyle for Nuzleaf, so... I'm just
making... Yeah, in the first silhouette, your response to seeing Grovyle was, oh, is that Nuzleaf?
Yeah, so I'm just making fun of myself. But why us? We haven't done anything wrong. Huh, I couldn't care less. You must have done something they can't tolerate. What? We haven't done anything bad! Don't think that we're like you! I don't care. You're wasting time losing your cool. Meanwhile, look. Here they come. What? Who are they? They're the jailers who do all the dirty work around here. They also happen to be Dustnoir's underlings. What?
By the way, fun fact, just really quick, you literally don't know a move that can hit Sableye.
Between me and you, or just me?
No, I do.
Okay.
Just you. I just think that's really funny.
Oh god. What? The great Dustnoirs? Hey, it's Dustnoir! Lord Dustnoir, the three have been tied to the stakes. Good. Dustnoir, sir! It's me, Dakariilf! Very well, Sableye. Those three, we need to be rid of them. What? Pay them no heed. You may get ready. Wahehehe! Wait a minute, Dustnoir, sir! What's wrong with you? Why are you doing this to us? Don't waste your breath. Instead, shh! Keep your voices down so they can't hear you. Keep my voice down? You two, if you want to get away, give me your full cooperation. What? Help you, Grovyle? There's no time to think. Or would you prefer to stick around for them? Hey, you there. Tell me, what can you do right now? What? What can I do? You asked me that out of nowhere? What to do? I know, I could throw something. I could pull it out of my pocket with my mouth somehow and throw it. No, an item's no good. We're tied up and unable to move. It should be something you can do instantaneously. That's easy for you to say. Probably use a move then. A move? That could work, but... No, that's no good. Yeah, okay. Then I guess just attack. Literally just our basic attack?
Yeah.
Incredible. That's it, that'll do. If it's just a regular attack, I can help too. Good. Then we are ready to begin. Very well. But be vigilant to the end. Don't take your eyes off them. Especially that Grovyle. Wehehe! Commence now.
I mean, they literally are. Like.
Wehehe! They're coming! Listen carefully. Sableye uses claws to strike. Yikes, that sounds scary! And that might just open one of the avenues for, one avenue for escape. The Sableye will unleash their fury swipes in a frenzy. That's our chance. If even one of their attacks were to hit the ropes binding us... Oh right! The ropes might come loose! Exactly. And if that happens, lash out with an attack, then flee. But... What if their fury swipes don't slash the ropes? And what if... What if the Sableye don't use fury swipes at all? Wah-heh-heh. If that happens, don't even think about it. What? Endure it! Wait for your chance! But if they keep going, we'll be finished before our chance comes! Hey! There's a break in the rope! Now, attack! Go! Wah! What is this? There. Gah! We can't see! Compose yourselves. It's only a luminous orb. Its effects wears off quickly. Blast it. That Grovyle. He fled using the flash from that luminous orb as cover. They won't get away with this. Come. Wah! That works. I got dirt in my mouth. We're safe. So Grovyle can use Dig? He sure knows many moves. We got out of that scrape, but we're not out of the woods yet. Let's get out of here and fast. Can Grovyle normally learn Dig?
I think so.
Okay. Honestly, using Dig is clever. That explains a lot about how Grovyle keeps escaping.
Yeah, Grovyle can learn Dig.
Come on, this way! We need to keep running till we hit the exit. Come on, faster, pick it up! This is the fastest I can go! Quit ordering me around! Anyway, Grovyle! What? Is this the future? That's right, you catch on fast. So it is, after all. Are we going to be able to get back to our world? Who knows? We just need to get away for now. If we get caught, returning home will be the least of your worries. Run faster. I can't! I'm exhausted! We're almost there. Look, the exit is right there. We did it! We're outside! And now we get to see how horrible the world is. What? What is this? This is our world? In the future. The boulders are floating. This is really a strange place, and it's horribly dark. Not even the wind blows. It's as if all movement, it's as if everything stopped. Exactly. What? Wah-heh-heh. Wah, I hear those Sableye. We have to keep running. Listen, Grovyle, I'm exhausted. There's no time to rest. If they catch us, we're done. Tough it out and run. That's easy for you to say. I can't. I have to rest. All right. This forms a natural alcove. This should shield us from view. After a quick rest, we'll have to get moving again. Wait a minute! When we escaped from the stockade, we cooperated with you because we had no other choice. But we didn't promise we'd go with you afterward. A bad Pokemon like you, you're not worth trusting. Dekorealf? Huh. So I'm the bad guy, and that Dusknoir is the good guy? Then how about explaining Dusknoir's actions earlier? It wasn't just me. They wanted you gone too. But that doesn't mean I should put my faith in you, Grovyle. Earning your trust isn't an easy task, it seems. I thought that having allies would help, but there's no point continuing together without trust. We'll go our separate ways. I'm staying on the move. You two should get moving as soon as possible. Good luck. Wait a second. You tell us to leave soon, but it's dark out now. It's hard to see where we're going. Instead of setting off again right away, shouldn't we wait for morning? Okay, Dekoreal, please. Shinx,
please. Children's game moment.
Time is currently clearly frozen. How is morning going to come if time is broken?
Yeah, for all the good I want to say about this game, it is a children's game.
God, yeah. Wouldn't it be better to wait to leave when it gets light out? That is impossible. I hate to say it, but morning never comes. What? This world, your future, it's a world of perpetual darkness. The sun never rises, so morning never comes. The darkness persists forever. Why? Because the planet has been paralyzed. The planet is paralyzed? The planet's paralysis. The planet's paralysis! That's right, I remember now. Dusknoir described the planet's paralysis before. It was nothing less than causing the planet's paralysis. The planet's paralysis? Yes, if a planet becomes paralyzed, all movement upon it ceases. When a time gear is removed, the flow of time slows in its region. As many more are taken, time slows in an ever larger area. Eventually, the planet's flow slows down so much that it stops entirely. Ultimately, the planet reaches a state of total paralysis. Yeah, they're just gonna keep saying it. If the planet is paralyzed, what happens to this world? In a world where the planet has become paralyzed, no winds blow, the day never comes. Neither spring nor summer ever comes. It's a world of unrelenting darkness. It would be no exaggeration to call it the complete ruin of the world. The planet's paralysis. Sure, this place resembles Dusknoir's description, but even then, it's hard to understand how the planet has been paralyzed in the future. You're free to believe or reject what I'm telling you. Either way, I suggest you leave here as soon as you can. Oh, 75%. So it'll eventually come. It'll just take like 4 days.
Yeah, but each day has a 25% chance of being fully paralyzed.
Ah. I'm going. Don't let those Sableye catch you. Violet, I don't know what to think anymore. Wasn't the planet's paralysis supposed to be caused by all those time gears going missing? That's why we all tried to stop Grovyle from stealing the time gears. We did everything we were supposed to, right? Uxie and the others said they would return the recaptured time gears to their rightful places. That should have prevented the planet's paralysis. But despite all our efforts, why is the planet still paralyzed? In our future? I don't know who or what to believe anymore. Wehehe. Where's the Sableye? We can't stay here. Let's get ready quickly so we can get moving. Okay, finally, gameplay. Let's see, where do I want to store?
Luckily, in the future, in the paralyzed future, you can still actually access all your storage items.
Yeah, no, it's just been sitting there for however long it's been.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I'm gonna probably want to eat the extra gummies we have.
Don't eat blue gummies.
Yep, I stored it.
Yeah.
I'll feed the gray to me. And the orange to you. Do you like orange?
Is orange fighting or ground?
I don't know, but I'm asking it if you like orange.
It seems like it was ground or fighting. So.
No, I'm asking if you like orange candy.
Oh, I do.
Good. Then it's good that I gave it to you. All right. I am as sad as I can be. Yeah, no, Game Boy Advance era and DS era pixel art is so good. All right, we can use a violent seed if we wish. Let's explore. Sure, the Sableye are trying to catch us, but I'm sure it'll be fine. You're doing a lot of damage. I don't like that. I do not like that at all. I like how the walls are actually just pits, so there's not really anything blocking you from doing attacks. This sucks! I'm in pain!
Yeah.
Shit! Nice. Alright, let's heal up. Oh, god damn it! It was fake out. That's two spots, right?
Yes.
Got it. And I got a level up. Ooh, new move. What do I want? It is faint attack.
I think you want to get rid of charm.
All right, goodbye, charm.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, Saul. Like, I mean, to be fair, this was a handheld game.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, it's not exactly comparable, but like, yeah. Also handheld stuff has progressed an absurd amount since the DS.
Yeah. I really, really, really do miss pixel art like this, though. It's so good. You really only get it in indie games. So I'm assuming that I got an IQ ability that tells me how many items are on each floor.
Yeah.
Okay, I thought that was like an item I ate in a previous dungeon, but no. I guess it's an IQ ability, so that's good.
And you can check your IQ abilities.
It's fine. Alright, there's two. Ah! Oh no, slow trap! Hi, Magmite!
Oh yeah, and Magmite can Magmite floats, so...
Yeah, it can just go right over the pits. There's a Ditto here! Oh dear. Yeah, I fully agree with that.
I think that's true.
Okay, let's go find that last item before we move on to the next floor. Hi, Drifloon! Oh, that was Ditto. What's the deal with Drifloon? I remember its lore being kind of terrifying. It kidnaps children, right?
Yeah, basic, more or less. Right here. So let's see, Drifloon Pokedex entries. Pokemon formed by the spirits of Pokemon and people, it loves damp, humid seasons. It tugs on the hands of children to steal them away, however it gets pulled around instead.
Aww.
It is whispered that any child who mistakes Drifloon for a balloon and holds on to it could wind up missing. Because of the way it floats aimlessly, an old folktale calls it a signpost for wandering spirits. These Pokemon are called the signpost for wandering spirits. Children holding them sometimes vanish. A Pokemon formed by the spirits of... Stories go that it grabs the hands of small children, drags them away to the afterlife. It dislikes heavy children.
Wow!
If for some reason its body bursts, it spills out. Its soul spills out with a screaming sound. Its round body is stuffed with souls and expands each time it leads someone away. When trying to make friends with children, Drifloon grabs them by the hand. This is a really funny Pokemon.
I don't think I like that.
Yeah, average ghost type. Perhaps seeking company, it approaches children, however it often quickly runs away again when the children play too roughly with it. The gathering of many souls, it gave rise to this Pokemon.
Okay, wait, hang on. I'm responding to something I just realized from one of the entries. Okay, it's up there. They said that it gets bigger every time it consumes a child's soul. And it also said that when it pops, its soul spills out with a screaming sound. That's the children screaming, isn't it?
Potentially.
I hate it. Okay. The Pokemon in the future are kind of dicks.
Yeah, it's this is kind of a difficulty spike.
Yeah, I can feel that. Oh god, I'm just trying to.
Said to lure away young children and carry them off to the afterlife. Some whisper that Drifloon are formed of reincarnated human souls, but these rumors are as of yet unconfirmed. And then everything else is just reused dialogue, or is reused entries.
Oh dear. Hi, who's joined
Hello.
Us?
Hello.
Alrighty.
It's Tactician Geek. Hello.
Long time no talk.
Alright, so how caught up are you on what's been happening?
I am about two streams behind.
Okay. Alright.
You know nothing.
I think the last thing I saw was the Wigglytuff special story.
Got it. Alright, Dekarilf, can you catch him up?
So let's see. We found the last few time gears in Uxie or Azelf and Masperitz Lakes. And Grovyle stole the one from, let's see, was it from Azelf?
From one of them.
Yeah, Grovyle stole one of them. The other one was like, inaccessible to Grovyle because it was sealed in crystal. One of those got stolen, the other one was protected. Dusknoir and the Lake Spirits did a cool plan to catch Grovyle.
They basically pretended that they were going to seal all the time gears away so Grovyle couldn't get any of them, and then led Grovyle right into a trap where Dusknoir caught him.
Yeah, and then, and Dusknoir revealed that he's from the future. I don't know if you were here for that.
No, that was last stream.
Okay, yeah. And what we learned from that, or no, so when he went back, Dusknoir grabbed the party,
when Dusknoir went back to the future to put Grovyle in future jail.
Yeah. He grabbed us and took him with it, and it turns out that he was not putting him in future jail, he was putting him in future execution.
Also, he was executing us.
Yeah, we also saw that Dialga is Dusknoir's boss, and the planet is paralyzed, despite us not doing, or despite the time gears not being stolen in the future.
Yeah, time gears aren't stolen, world's still paralyzed. Also, Dialga seems to be in charge of Dust Noir trying to kill us. I wonder what's happening with this time god Pokemon.
It's a big dude. I like Dialga. What a funny guy.
God, this really is Xenoblade 1.
God.
Xenoblade 1 doesn't have time travel, I don't think.
The original version of Xenoblade.
Okay, well.
Alright, then who's Rhyne?
I guess in this case it'd be Dust Noir, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I guess so. Okay. Good news is enough Pokemon left us alone. Maybe they're all dead that we could heal. Those Drifblim are fucking horrible. We are out of belly. I'm gonna need to consume Appful.
Yeah, by the way, Drifblim has Aftermath, which is a funny ability where
it blows up. I've noticed.
Yeah.
It's very annoying.
It's very funny.
Oh god, okay, how about we don't? Yeah, no, come with me. Oh no. Oh, it didn't do the exploding. God, the future's kind of awful. I hate it. Oh, that was dumb. I like how Onyx is just standing there, not able to figure out how to go around. Just around.
Yeah, God, what a funny Pokemon Onyx is.
Oh, hi, you know there's that, two.
Do you know that Onyx has a base attack stat of 40?
That sounds low.
It is. It's, I think, Oddish's attack stat.
Oh, amazing. So despite being a giant pile of intimidating rocks, it is actually very weak. Very weak rocks.
Yeah, and it also has really low HP. Which is funny because it essentially means that it's, by design, does the lowest possible damage that it can, with Bide, which is like Brock's signature move, I guess, in the
mainline games.
Yeah, well, in Kanto games, because he has a, like, actual moves in, when you fight him post-game in the Johto games, I think, but...
Yeah.
So the way Bide works is that you don't move for two turns, and then you return double the damage that you took over those two turns to whatever Pokemon is on the field. Yeah, exploding balloons and magnets and gem ghosts. But because of Onyx has really high defense and really low HP, the actual like numerical the damage is really low, so Bide doesn't really do anything for
him. That's fantastic.
Onyx is just kind of a mess.
Oh, bye, Grumpig. Bye! What just happened? Did you splash? It fell off the edge and then it warped.
Yeah, I think that's what happened.
So explain that series of events.
Yeah, one second. Let me just...
I like how a lot of the dungeons do have, like, a specific character to the way that their maps are randomly generated, despite being randomly generated.
The user, when you use Crunch, it randomly flops you to an adjacent tile. So it used Splash and fell off the edge of the map.
Okay, and so Foxy filled in the rest. That's very funny.
Yeah.
Oh god, there's more Ditto.
I like Ditto. What a funny little guy.
Oh, thank goodness that was a Ditto.
Wait, splash can't be used when gravity... when that's fine.
Wait, what?
Okay, so there's a move called gravity. It does a couple things. One, like all moves get more accurate. I think it's
real quick. What is be patient?
I think it's just I forget exactly what it does. I don't know if I care. Let me. The Pokemon will stop moving if its HP is low.
Okay. Look, Violet! Could that be the exit over there? Let's go over there! Wow, look how much this water is flowing.
Yeah.
Did we put some distance between us and those Sableye? Let's rest a little now. Oh, there's water there! Yeah, just try drinking it. What? This waterfall! This water isn't flowing at all! It isn't falling! The gushing water is totally suspended in space!
Oh my god. God, I love this game, but...
Is Grovel right after all? Has time really stopped in the future? Why did Dusknoir bring us here? The great Dusknoir who was so kind to us. It's called abuse tactics.
It's called lying.
I don't know what to believe anymore. It's called gaslighting. You got gaslit.
Yeah, gaslight. Gaslight gatekeep. Grovyl boss.
If only there was some way of finding out the truth. Oh, I know. There is a way of getting at the truth. Huh? Your dimensional scream. Just scream at the waterfall. Use your dimensional scream, Violet. Touch this frozen water. Now, it's not frozen. If it was frozen, it would be ice. Who knows? You may see something. Oh, I understand. That's true. It's worth a try. Touching that frozen water, it might give us clues about what's happening to us. We can't dawdle. Those Sableye will catch up to us. Let's do this quickly. Well? Can you see anything? Nope. I'm not sensing anything. No, huh? Ah, that's disappointing. It would have been reassuring if we could begin to understand what's happening. We didn't learn anything at all. We spent a lot of time here. If we don't hurry, those Sableye will get to us. Let's get ready and go. Okay, where's Kangaskhan? There's Kangaskhan. Let's see, what do we want to store? I have Oran Berries, I should make more use of those. Store the extra stamina, store the special, store the Insomniscope. Don't need all the Heal Seeds or all the Blast Seeds. I'll keep two. What does Mix Elixir do?
we'll check info. But it's one of the funny items that does something silly.
Ah, lovely.
Oh, you can't check info.
Yeah.
Here, one sec.
I have a fuck ton of gummies. Should I just start eating them?
You should probably save some of those for blending.
Blending doesn't really seem to do much, to be honest.
Did you ever actually try blending? Did you ever try blending anything? Did you ever try blending gummies?
Yeah, we did. We did many gummies last time.
Oh, okay. Yeah, blending was not in time. Mix Elixir is really good. It is really good if you're Linoone.
Okay.
Um, uh, it will restore all, it fully restores all PP of all of Alinoon's moves and restores 5 Bally.
I got self-cure, what's that do?
You will just sometimes decide that, you don't have a status effect.
Nice.
Yeah, it is pretty good.
I'm shoving you full of gummies. You're welcome. Alright, mix elixir. Only for- okay, I see what you mean. What the hell?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'm gonna throw that drop ice. Will throwing that drop ice at an enemy actually do anything, or is it worthless?
I think it does. Let me...
Alright, I'm gonna store the mix elixir.
I don't know what it... I'm not quite sure what it does to an NPC Pokemon.
Okay, looks like Twitch wants to run ads. Twitch wants to run ads real quick, so let's go ahead and run those ads so they're out of the way.
Oh, yeah, that's probably a good idea.
Especially since we are between dungeons.
I love advertising.
I love 3 minutes of ads!
Oh god, is it 3 minutes? Oh,
yeah, they want 3 minutes an hour.
Okay, yeah, we've been playing for a while.
Alright, Alright, I'm gonna store a couple more orbs, just because I don't really use orbs a lot, and these ones I don't see being useful right now. I'm gonna keep that plane seed, because it could be a good, quick improvement to our belly. God, I have so many throw items.
I mean, yeah, that's... you can get rid of sticks, and Geopebbles and sticks are probably completely useless to you.
Alright. I'll store them for now.
Like, I think you're at the point of the game where you should be getting the better thrown items, commonly enough.
Yeah, I've got 26 Graveler Rock, 16 Silver Spike, and 73 Iron Thorn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we got about a minute 50 left on the ads. Wow, look at this one job we weren't able to do before we went to the future!
And now that Pokemon will be paralyzed forever.
Yeah, it's great. Okay, that's good. I'm going through the IQ abilities. That's good.
Yeah, I don't think there's any IQ abilities that are bad.
Mm-hmm.
Except maybe exclusive move user, but like for the most part...
That should be fine generally.
Yeah, like unless you have a really specific scenario, you want to keep that on. Like, that's good, mm-hmm. because the AI is bad enough. If it considered just hitting the basic attack button as well, that would not be good. And course checker is just like,
yeah,
making sure that things actually hit.
Sorry, I'm being quiet. I'm doing some more messing around with the black magic.
Oh, yeah. Congrats on getting that working.
Yeah.
On the what now?
Capture card. Black Magic Intensity Pro.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Still can't get the Switch audio working, and still can't get the Switch to display at higher than 480p.
Yeah, I think
for that I might just need a new HDMI cable.
Yeah, HDMI cables can be weirdly sensitive with capture cards. All right, looks like ads are officially done, so let's do a quick save. And then move on to the next section of the caves.
I like that they call the main menu top menu in this game. I just think that's a funny little thing.
Yeah. Dark Hill, Dork Hill. Heal Seed, Pure Seed, Embargo. If I was Chugga Conroy, I would believe that video game review embargoes were a Pokemon thing.
I love preferences.
It's funny because he literally said that like yesterday, I think.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
Oh, hello! That is a nice move for a pinch. Whoor! Nice seed, rather. Goodness!
Yeah. Is that a lookalike?
I mean, I can double check.
It does not look like it. It's not on here.
Yeah, its info says it just warps it straight to the stairway.
Yeah.
Oh, hi! Look, that's an actual Gligar. Or Gliscor.
That's a Gliscor. I love Gliscor, honestly. What a cool Pokemon.
It looks like it's plotting my demise.
Yeah, it's a funny guy.
So let me guess, when we get to the end of this dungeon, we're going to find ourselves somewhere very familiar.
Who can say, really?
I'm guessing based on tropes and how
you
those
just,
work.
You just got your item knocked off. Go back.
If we see half of the Statue of Liberty sticking out of the sand, we'll know.
Congrats on your level up. Where's my item?
It's way back. Like,
oh, there it is.
I knocked it off a while ago.
How? I did not know that that could happen. Oh, dear.
Yeah, like, that's what knockoff does. Gliscor hit you with it a while ago. I don't know if you, like, saw the pop-up, but...
Well, that was rude. I did not see. I didn't see the pop-up. Thank you for catching that. I would have been salty. I mean, I have spares, but they're in storage.
Yeah, and all... Yeah, it's the... competitive player in me has been extremely conditioned to like think about knockoff constantly.
Like, well, you should knock that off. Sorry, I had to do it.
I wasn't gonna say anything, but it's not bad. It's really impactful, because like a lot of held items are super important, and getting rid of them. Oh, that's right. You can't hit Ghastly because it's in the wall.
Yeah, I've realized.
And like specifically, like knockoff is. Impactful in singles, more like way more than doubles. Just because singles battles tend to last longer, but yeah, that's.
God, it would have been really funny if this path I'm on right now was just an immediate dead end.
Yeah, it would have been funny. But yeah, singles are what happens when Game Freak balances everything around, balances the game around doubles. I honestly love singles.
I'm on fire.
That's not good.
No, it's not.
Oh, you're just like those guys from Dragon Ball Z Abridged, because you can see the future and you're on fire.
God, I haven't thought about... Yeah, it's like, singles are the main mode in the game, and like... Then they just... But then... The game just does such a bad job preparing someone who plays it for competitive. Like, you have to have external resources. It's so funny. And by funny, I mean annoying. Yeah, that was a little bit of a silly moment.
Yeah, I'm gonna eat an orange berry.
Yeah.
Consume orange.
Alright, do I have to eat a berry to a Ross berry to get rid of the burn?
No, I don't think so.
I'm surprised I still have it.
Yeah, I didn't. Did you not, like, I would have thought the status cure thing you IQ would have stopped it. Did you not just get that, or am I thinking, or does that work differently from how I think it does?
Faster than usual from status problems.
Okay.
Well, if this is faster than usual, then I'm scared.
I mean, burn doesn't go away in the main series. So maybe.
Oh.
Maybe that has stayed consistent. Also, like, statuses do always reset when you go up a floor.
Mm-hmm. I hate that the enemy Pokemon are getting better at dodging. They learned from Piccolo and they weren't supposed to.
Yeah, these Pokemon the Pokemon in here specifically, are good at dodging because they are, like, just all ghost types, so they can just hide in the wall. And it's really funny.
I don't think it's very funny. What was that?
How dare enemies in this RPG get tougher as the game progresses?
Yeah, seriously, how dare?
What is this progression BS?
Yeah.
Ooh, do not wake up Ghastly. Got a steel wing. There's the exit. Hi, Bennett.
Oh no, it's Puppet.
Yeah, that's been his profile picture for how many years? All of them?
As far back as I can remember.
It's the puppet Five Nights at Freddy.
Oh god. Different puppet, but also,
Yeah, oh, you mean the Puppet Master and the...
Yeah, Puppet Master.
Oh, he's Deku Link.
Oh, he's changed, didn't he?
Oh, yeah.
He was Bennett for, like, years and years and years.
Mm. I think he might actually still be Bennett on Twitter.
Okay.
I need to double check, though.
You are getting bullied, and I don't know what to do about it. That works. Alright, I'm feeding you an orange berry.
Yeah, that's probably smart. I am a little low on health.
Yeah, you're getting bullied, and I hate it.
Oh, I should probably mention this, I guess. Just, like, we have Soul in chat. I don't know if we have anyone else in chat who has not, like, been watching the series. I did a little trolling, I guess. That's...
Trolling?
Yeah, I trolled the game.
Oh.
Into making Giddy usable.
Yeah, you made me better.
Yeah, so Skitty normally has normalize in this game. And you might, so what normalize does is it makes all... this is notably very bad.
You cut out, but you were going to say when you cut out, it makes all moves normal type.
Yes, and it's very bad. So I, that got removed.
I assume this was the entire reason we got rid of Normalize.
Not the entire reason, but it would have, it was, it's a very big part of it. But like, there's also like Mount Bristle has a lot of rock types.
Ah, yeah.
And like, and there's just a lot of dungeons that have a decent amount of rock types because like, you know, they're sort of
rocky.
Yeah. But yeah.
Don't you want to be able to use Thunder Wave on ground types?
You do. That is the funny thing about that is you can just do that in this game without Normalize.
Oh my gosh.
I'm just going off of Chugga Conroy's Let's Play.
Yeah, that's I sort of assumed based on the fact that you mentioned that specifically.
Holy shit, this dungeon is rough.
Yeah, this is
I've played 3 Pokemon games and finished 1.
Which one did you finish?
Why?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Just because with EXP share, I didn't have to grind the hell out of everything.
Why did I feed you the apple?
Because I was hungry.
Yeah, you're right. You were hungry. I'm just being nice.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
But yeah, why does have that going for it? It's just that, like...
Yeah, see, that's the joke I thought we were gonna go with.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, I just was distracted by fucking hating Gen 6. Well, not Gen 6. Hating X and Y.
Yeah, the first game I played was Fire Red, and the only reason I ever beat that is because the level gap between the last gym leader and Victory Road is kind of crazy, and I was like, I am not grinding out 10 more levels.
Yeah,
for this.
Kanto has weird levels. I mean, so does Johto, but like Kanto and Johto are definitely like, you can sort of tell they were the first two entries in the series.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up on Gold, and then I played a little bit of Ruby, and I played a little bit of Pokemon Yellow, and then I tried Pokemon Pearl, and then I hated Pokemon.
Yeah. And then I showed, I made you look at the Unova starters, and you decided, and you said, I think you said you were glad that you stopped very, because people are so mean to Oshawott online.
Volt Tackle.
Already. Oh yeah, this is another funny thing that I did. I think you can forget Spark.
All right. So explain to me what the funny thing you did. Taught yourself Volt Tackle?
I did maybe give Shinx access to Volt Tackle, which is not normal.
Well, yeah, it's an electric type move.
Yeah, I was gonna make that joke.
Yeah, so Volt Tackle is normally only learned by Pikachu, which is really funny because Pikachu is good at doing. Pikachu isn't really good at... Yeah, like, Pikachu's okay using it, I guess. Funny moment when Game Freak does not make any physical electric attacks.
Okay, Whisker Biscuit, listen. I listen to Dakariel talk all the time about how much Game Freak hates the Shinx line. I'm completely fine with cheating.
Yeah, you've had to listen to me talk about that too, Whisker Biscuit. Also, like, yes, I cheated, but also it was funny, so,
So mean! Just trying to even the odds a bit.
Yeah. Look, I could have gone all out and, like, I was really considering doing, like, I was really considering fucking, like, looking into how to program new moves to really cheat. So you're lucky that I didn't do that.
I think that would be kind of cool, actually, if you did that.
It would be, but yeah, that's why I wanted, that was why I gave, I wanted Volt Tackle. If you saw that damage number.
Oh my god, it's Dustmar! Kill him! Kill Dusclops! Kill him!
Yeah. I love Dusclops. It's so... okay. Well, I mean, they put it in Isle of Armor. And they couldn't not put Shinx in Legends Arceus.
Oh my god, Shinx is so cute in Legends Arceus.
Yeah, I love the little violence creature. But my point of complaint is more, Luxray is, like, from a gameplay design standpoint, not very well put together. And it makes me sad. Because I think it's a really cool little character.
I killed Dustmar's child. I'm so happy with myself.
Yeah.
This sucks. Oh no!
Yeah.
So I'm assuming that there are ways that there are, like, programs that will let you put in a rescue code, and it gives you a here's your not dead anymore code.
I don't know how this works. I'm pretty sure that it's multiplayer.
It is, but the multiplayer, if I remember from Blue Rescue Team correctly, when you I get a code to give to another player. They complete the rescue mission, and then they get a code to give to me, and that revives me. So there should be a way to put in my rescue code into, like, an online program, and it'll give you the you're saved now code. Can you Google that real quick?
Let's see.
This dungeon's fucking rough!
That is for DX.
I will get the password while you're doing that.
Wars of Sky.
While waiting for rescue.
Oh, here we go. Generators.
Are you just kind of stuck until someone rescues you then?
I can also give up and try again for my last save.
Okay.
Okay, so let's see.
Oh, no. How do I send, receive? No, I don't want to receive the mail. I want to send the mail. Get help. There we go. Send SOS mail. Password.
And once you have that, let me just...
It's up.
Okay. So we have 2NK 23 equals... Big RJ Octothorpe S Y 8 W Octothorpe at 0 3.
Geez, how many variables are they controlling for here?
A ton. Because, like, they're controlling the actual dungeon.
Yeah.
They're controlling for the dungeon layout and the dungeon layout.
Where you are on the floor, what floor you're on.
What floor. Your party Pokemon are encoded in this.
Yeah.
As well as, like, status of, like, what items you have, what Pokemon took you out.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And scene 1H. God, I hope I'm not formatting this wrong somehow. M9 plus 1 plus M8.
In the meantime, while we're doing this, I'm going to run ad. I'm going to run an ad. Just to calm Twitch down.
9M% 9S. Okay, I think I have something.
Alright, take a screenshot of the password real quick, just in case, and then I'll back out. Let me know when you have the screenshot.
Let me just... Okay, that should be good. I'm just putting it... I'm just sending it to you so I have it on hand.
Got it. Alright, get help.
I took a screenshot too.
Awesome. Receive AOK mail, password. Do you have the password?
Yeah, so that's all. I can read it off, but it's also in that image I sent you if you think faster.
Alright, let's enter this in. 7. Ampersand. 1. K. 8. Plus 0 M W 8 Q ampersand.
Ampersand is such a funny word.
It is. 6 Y Q Y F 9 6 dash 9 ampersand KS. While I'm doing this, someone count on my screen how many of these characters are valid, and then give me that number. I'm gonna do some math with it later, like put it in Discord.
Valid as in
the ones. The ones that I'm allowed to put in, the white ones.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, S P F
48.
Alright. N percent P.
So if the yellow ones aren't valid, then what's the purpose of them?
Oh, the red ones.
Okay. I thought you meant on the top screen.
No, on the keyboard.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, I got 31.
Okay, good. Yeah, we got the same thing.
Okay.
Sorry, I thought you meant what's on top.
Nah, you're good. You're good. Okay, 31. And then, yeah, the other question is how many characters are total in the... But that's 6 by 3 by 3 is 18 by 3. Or 6 by 9 is 54. 54 and 31. I'm writing that down real quick.
So just trying to get how many different
I want to calculate how I want to calculate like how big the like how many bits are in the password.
So let's see, 54 is just 54 times 31?
No, 31 is 31 one short of...
31 to the 54th.
It would be a bit easier to go in terms of bits, just for my brain. So you would take the base 2 logarithm of 31, but you would want, it's right off, one off from a multiple of two, or power of 2, so... Base 2 logarithm of 32, take that times 54, that's the number of bits in the password.
Okay, so wait.
Okay, what were you saying that it was?
Base log 2 of 32, then take that and multiply it by 54.
Okay. Log two of 31.
Of 32.
Log 2 of 32.
That's 5.
Yeah. Times 54.
Yep.
270.
270. 270 bits. Got it. Hi, Jackie! Jackie, you've missed some shit.
Lot.
You've missed some shit. You want to know what happened? You want to know what happened? One, I died. So Dust Noir captured Grovyle and then went to put Grovyle in Future Prison and then also put us in Future Prison. We were kidnapped by Dust Noir and we were almost executed. And apparently Dialga's the evil one. Despite the fact that we saved the time gears, Dialga broke time. So time's broken in the future. We're stuck in the future, running for our lives.
I mean, we don't know that Dialga broke time. We just
Dialga's the time god Pokemon, and clearly the villain.
We just know that saving the time.
Oh my god! I have a limited number of chances.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah, that's funny.
But yeah, thank you for killing the Pokemon that killed me.
Yeah,
it was very helpful.
Yeah, you're welcome for, Dustin was from the future. I think you had to leave, at some, before that got revealed on either the last stream or the one before it.
How many did we say? 270?
I think yes.
Okay, someone write that down so I don't forget it. Please and thank you. And then I'm gonna do math with that later, but that's a lot. That is a big. Okay, that's an XI seed. Thank you!
I put it in the chat.
Awesome. I just want to know because I'm a fucking nerd! Slip seed. Oh! I can walk on water!
Yeah, it turns you into Jesus. But yeah, it's a stop. Yeah, I'm surprised, Whisker Biscuit, that you're complaining about us doing numbers and or crunching numbers and doing data entry, and not the fact that we just kind of blatantly cheated again.
Yeah, you're so mad about Volt Tackle, but not about this. Oh my God! It can destroy the wall.
Oh yeah. Explosions do that. I forgot to mention that.
That's cool and terrify.
Yeah, all right. I think it's a neat little touch.
All right, time to kill another one of Dust Noir's children.
Yeah, I think it's really funny that Dusclops is better than Dust Noir.
That is so much damage, though. God damn, no wonder you wanted it.
Yeah. I forget what level I learned charge at.
Oh, good. Gengar. Hi, asshole.
God, I love Gengar. What a funny little guy. I know you are having Mystery Dungeon. Did you play blue? Or I don't think it matters.
Yeah, I played blue rescue team, but it doesn't matter. But yeah, yes, I am having flashbacks.
Yeah,
absolute fucking bastard, man.
I'm trying to remember. Is Gengar... God, I haven't played that, and it's been a while since I've watched a playthrough of it. Is Gengar... pick up that Reviver Seed.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what to get rid of.
Eat a Heal Seed. You have a bunch.
Yeah. But yeah, no, I was convinced for a long while that... Actually, no, I'm not going to say that. Because Whisker Biscuit's playing through it.
Oh, that's right. I'm trying to remember. Is Gengar in that game... more or less annoying than... that's so true, Soul. Yeah, you've told me about that before, and I still think that that doesn't make any. I still think I'm still going to firm actually you every time.
Okay, how does it not make sense though?
Well, pushes up glasses. I'm not going to actually say it on stream. But I've Irm actually'd you about this in the past.
I don't remember what you said, but they are a dick. Therefore, I'm right.
Yeah, you're that's so true. Let's see.
Ooh, shockwave. Do we want that?
Shockwave might be good. I'm trying to remember. I forget how it works in this game. Let me just.
What do I want to get rid of in exchange?
You can get rid of Embargo. And let me just look up how it works. Okay. Yeah. Shockwave is good. It travels up to 10 tiles away. And it ignores accuracy. It's pretty good.
Up to 10 tiles away and ignores accuracy?
Yeah.
Do I want to teach that to you now?
I was honestly going to suggest teaching it to yourself, because Shinx learns a better long-distance attack.
Okay. I'm fairly certain. Sure. Then what do I want to replace with? Replace with it.
I think of these tackle, and I know you like using tackle.
It's a good basic move, but it's also a weak move.
Yeah, and like for having a good basic, like your basic attack.
I have feint attack for that.
Well, that too, but like, yeah. I think you can afford it. Let's see.
Line of sight, okay. Yeah. Oh, right, Thorn. Got it.
Yeah, so in... Okay, so let me just... Now...
But yeah, the only reason I like Tackle is just because it's a good basic high PP move that I can use repeatedly throughout a dungeon.
Yeah, but like also, again, yeah. We have
Feint attack.
And your standard just like hit A button attack.
Also true.
If you want more high PP attacks, just drink more water.
Yeah.
Sorry, had to do it.
I'm shaking my head disappointedly, even though I probably would have made the same joke if I had thought of it. We're both just gonna pass over the Flasher, I see.
Yeah, Flash isn't... I don't think Flash is super worth it.
I think that's line of sight. That is line of sight. Beautiful.
Yeah.
So is evolution a thing in these games?
It is at the, but you need, You can't evolve until you've finished the main story.
Yeah.
Okay.
In
so it's a post-game thing.
Yeah, it was interesting. There was like a lore thing behind it in Blue Rescue Team, I remember.
Okay, that's interesting. I didn't know about that.
Haha, nice. 69. It's the funny number. Ooh, music stopped. We've been climbing a long time now.
I don't think so, honestly. Like, I would love one, but like...
Wow, look at that, Violet!
Mm.
It was true. The future really is a world of darkness. We need to find Kingdom Hearts! That cluster of lights.
I was going to say the day man, but okay.
It's beautiful, but those lights, isn't that the stockade? Hey, Violet, the great Dusmore saved us more than once. He taught us many things, too. That's why I came to really respect him. But was Dusmore deceiving us? Even after all this, I still can't believe it.
This was all a trick. He deceived us.
I don't know what to believe anymore. I'm feeling all jumbled up. Dekarilf? What should we do now? I'm gonna be honest, whenever I read your name, for some reason I think of like a Riolu with a gun.
Like
Dekarilf?
Yeah.
That's funny.
I'm now
picturing a Lucario with dressed like the Heavy from Team Fortress 2.
Amazing. How far do we have to run? How do we get back to our own world? Everyone at the guild, I wonder how they're doing. Are they worried about us? Are we about to have a jump cut back to the guild and play as, I don't know, Bidoof? Wigglytuff, Chatot, Bidoof, and everyone else? I wonder if they're doing well. I miss the guild! Even though they had a 90% tax, I want to see everyone. Dekarilf's feeling pretty down. It's only natural. What's happened so far? It's also hard to believe. I'm scared too. But I can't give up now. If we don't keep going, those Sableye will catch us. I've got to do something to cheer up Dekarilf. But words of support will seem like false comfort right now. If there was something I could say... Even though the only words I'm ever allowed to speak are in my head, and whatever is out loud, I just kind of make an animation. Something that offers a glimmer of hope. If only there was some hope, we could work toward it. It could be anything. I just need to think of something. Hmm? What is it? Let's just go home. It's simple as that. What? Let's return to our world? How are we supposed to return? Well, sure, it'd be great if we could go back to our world, but how? What? We're gonna first find Grovyle. So if we do find Grovyle, then what? I wanna ask him how he came to our world. Ask him something? Oh, I see. Grovyle went to our world from here the first time. So Grovyle should know how to travel to our world. But isn't Grovyle a bad Pokemon? I think you should probably reconsider that basic premise at this point.
Yeah.
Didn't he come to our world to steal the time gears? How could I trust anything he would say? Also, I just saw your evidence against my hypothesis about Blue Rescue Team.
I only just sent it because I was looking up other stuff for a while before I managed to get that.
Okay, but also, like, you're wrong because he could have traveled.
That list does include traveling. Like, that's...
Oh, well, I haven't clicked on the link yet. Also, yes, but Grovyle apologized for trying to kill us, so, like, that completely makes up for it.
Yeah, Grovyle also said, I don't want to kill you.
Yeah, he apologized! Murder's okay if you apologize to your victim afterwards.
Also, I don't think he actually murdered anyone. He only knocked people out.
How could I trust anything he would say? What about you? Do you trust him? We kind of have to, because we were in the same situation as him. It kind of seems like we're forced to trust him. Well, I can't trust him. A Pokemon like that, never. There's no way that I can trust him. There's just no way, but I understand. I don't know why, but Dusknoir wants to get rid of us. That means the only other Pokemon we know here in the future, that leaves only Grovyle. We have no choice. We must pin our hopes on Grovyle. Well then, okay. Okay, let's track down Grovyle. Let's meet with Grovyle and ask him how we can return to our world. Okay, I will say, literally the only logic I have behind that Blue Rescue Team theory is just, I hate both of those characters. That's the only logic behind it. Dekorealf, let's go. Let's go after Grovyle. Violet, thank you. You tried to pick me up because I was feeling down, even though you should be just as scared as I am. I'm sorry, even though I have my closest and most precious friend with me. And they were roommates. I was worried all alone, and almost gave up alone, when in fact I'm not alone. I won't give up anymore, because you're by my side, I can be brave. I'm gonna be fine now. So let's keep going. Let's get back to our world, together. So we can be roommates again! I was just sent something real quick. Oh, cool! Udon Entertainment is offering Mega Man merch for Mega May, including Mega Man Rainbow Foil Head Tee. Okay, that's gay. And also, Mega Man Rainbow Head Pin. Gay. And also, a little charm of Tron Bonne in one of her mechs. I think that's the Gustav. Oh, that's very cute. I love it. Since Grovyle left, it's been one straight shot without any branching paths. So Grovyle should be ahead of us on the same path. Let's go. Let's catch up to Grovyle. Okay. I like how the map for the future is pretty small, so you get an idea that we're not going to be here that long necessarily.
No, the world just shrunk.
No, we are clearly in, like, the last section of Final Fantasy VI, apparently. I can store my used TM.
Oh, God, yeah, that's right. I forgot that TMs, like, stay in your inventory as garbage.
As we all know, CDs only hold one copy of a program.
Indeed. Yeah. I've got so many Reviver Seeds, I should have made sure I had them with me when I went into that dungeon.
Yeah.
Oh well, now I have two in my inventory. Can be sold for big money! Oh, I needed to sort. Oops.
Big money, big prizes.
I have so many orbs. I do not use orbs.
Yeah, you... Like... I don't think you need to use orbs, per se, but, like, at least at this point, like, you're probably getting... You should try and use orbs more.
Yeah. Okay, because, what do I do with the TM? Can I throw it away? Oh, I can restore it using recycle.
Yeah, I don't know if you have anyone who has recycle or anything.
Should I just throw it away?
I mean, put it in storage in case you find someone with recycle.
I don't think it would let me. Yeah, it won't let me.
Okay, then I mean, I guess you can throw it away. It doesn't really matter in that case.
Yeah, because right now it's just going to be annoying.
Yeah.
Sealed Ruin. Are there going to be unknown here?
I don't know. There will be seals. Think so.
This is a aesthetic. Twist band.
Just twist band too, I forget.
Maintains attack and special attack.
Oh, okay, so they can't get lowered.
Yeah.
That's actually kind of decent, depending on, I mean, like, if you have them.
Yeah, this is the no shops or towns or anything. We are stranded in the future where time does not exist.
Yeah, it's no post-apocalyptic. Yeah, literally just dungeon after dungeon after dungeon. You can't recruit anyone, no shops, no side quest chances. You just have to keep running through dungeons.
I can't believe Pokemon Mystery Dungeon ripped off the second disc of Xenogears.
God.
Yeah, I love Xenogears.
I'm feeding you a floor seed. Does that only last for this floor?
I think.
Okay, well, congratulations on your worthless floor seed.
I mean,
I'll explore a bit.
Yeah.
It's a nose pass! Probopass! Proboscis pass.
My favorite Pokemon that you can't raid in Generation 5 without giving it a nickname first.
Oh.
What?
Because ass.
Yeah.
Wake up slap!
What does wake up slap do?
Wakes up Pokemon?
I mean, cute. Hit ratio power. A fighting move might be good for you, but I don't know what you want to forget for it. I think actually waking someone up probably would be not very useful in most cases.
So too situational to be worth it?
Yeah, I think check feint attack really quick.
But that's my high PP move.
No, I just want to check its info.
Never misses, dark physical, always hit, power ratio 4.
Okay, yeah, in that case. Check. Okay, what's the... check the power ratio on fake out.
It is 4.
Okay, so there's, so this could go either way, honestly. I would probably... Zen Headbutt might be your least useful move, but, like... It's really subjective in this case. Like, you could not take...
Like, yeah, I'm Zen gonna... Headbutt I'm
does
gonna,
a lot of damage.
I'm gonna not take Wake Up Slap.
Yeah.
A box. Sinister box. I'm so full.
What's inside the box? Where are you? Here, go
inside
go,
the box. I'm looking through.
You could probably just like. It's a Zinc Band boost special defense. You could probably use. Just like throw out one of your orbs if you wanted to, but it's not that important.
I am very sorry if that came through. The garbage truck just came through.
It was mostly cut out by filter.
Okay. So weird time for garbage truck to come through. Especially since the school literally just got out.
Hmm.
You'd think they wouldn't want to fight against all the crazed parents.
Yeah, it came for the used TM. Oh god! Well, you're fine, I think. Natural gift.
I don't think natural gift is worth it.
Yeah, but sorry to bring this back up, but the black magic didn't really seem to be having any trouble with PS1 games on my PS2.
Dang, I am jealous because mine refuses to work with PS1 games on my PS2.
It's like I'm playing Spyro 1 right now, and I'm getting like maybe some frame skips, but that's about it.
Yeah, I mean, that's to be expected. Your computer's a little bit old, and it's going to be doing all the video processing on the CPU.
Yeah, I love computers. I love hardware. I love consistency.
Yeah, I am really glad that it's working out so well for you. That's good. It is a quirky as fuck card, but once you get it working, it works real nice.
Yeah, and I should have that component cable coming in later today.
Yeah, that'll make a.
It might already be in my mailbox.
Yeah, that cable should work for both the PS2 and the PS3, and make them look real good.
Yeah.
It'll let you PS3 without needing to worry about the HDCP bullshit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Shame I don't have that many PS3 games to go through.
Yeah.
We can watch the greatest movie of all time.
Which movie?
Metal Gear Solid 4.
Ah, yes! Fantastic movel.
Movel.
I really should be fighting more enemies to get levels, but I'm scared.
Yeah, this is like, in terms of places to be doing that, this is probably one of the scariest.
One of the scariest to be trying to get levels, or?
Yeah, like honestly just focus on getting through these dungeons.
Got it.
I'm trying to think like what all PS3 games I have, because I have...
Alright, so we are at a rest floor, and Twitch wants 1 more minute of ads, and they're about to start. So I'm going to run that 1 minute of ads while we do inventory work.
Okay.
And also you can look at the thing I sent you.
I can.
But yeah, so I think the PS3...
I call bullshit. There is no way that he would ever do such a thing.
Okay. I you're right, I guess.
Okay. So no item storage, just a halfway point. So let's wait for that ad to finish up.
Yeah, I think I have Ratchet and Clank, Tools of Destruction, and Kraken Time, Sly 4, Metal Gear Solid 4, Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
Look at Skitty go, yip, yip!
Yeah, look at it. Look at you go.
Yip, yip! And you're just bouncing. That is a great time for it to cut off for an ad. Okay, ads should be done now, so let's get moving.
I love incidental censorship.
We must be getting close to the bottom now. I mean, I'm right here. I mean, what? We have to catch up to Groval soon. Let's keep it up. I've gone quite deep. There's not much farther now. It's a ball! If I get through here, I should be at the forest. The Sableye are coming. There's no time to waste. That reminds me. I wonder how those two are doing. Have they eluded the Sableye? Oh, forget it. This isn't the time. I have to give priority to my own mission no matter what. I vow to complete it even if it means making sacrifices. Time to go. You there! Stop! Hmm? Who's there? You invade this place with no warning. Then you disturb our slumber. Then without apology you try to leave? Who's there? Who are you? You dare to anger us. We expect you to pay for these insults. Where are you? Quit hiding and reveal yourself. Okay, this is going to be someone we know already.
Grovile's going to pay for his insolence.
You accuse us of hiding? We do not hide. We are here. We are Spirit Home. There is no mercy for those who transgress against us. Gah! Okay, it's not someone familiar, and Grovile is dead.
Kind of the main thing that I was thinking about when I was like, wow, you really should not have normalized.
Got it.
Because Spiritomb is
just...
Spiritomb is Dark Ghost. So, before you learned Feign Attack this stream, you only had moves that would do nothing to it.
Got it. So it's very good that I have Feign Attack.
Yeah. And, like, also it doesn't completely matter because, like, in this game, there isn't immunity. There's just I forget what the actual multiplier is. You just do low damage.
Ooh, Hyper Beam!
Hyper Beam isn't great.
Okay. But it's hyper! And it's a beam!
That is true.
I feel like I should be concerned that they're giving me so many berries in the area.
Maybe you're just in the Beria.
Oh my god.
Money. Oh god! I snooze. Therefore I lose. Oh god, this is bad. No, why? Oh no!
Yeah, and this is Gen 4, so Pixel 8 is not real.
Well, Grovile is dead. Spiritomb ate them.
Yeah.
And that's about it. Also, I'm worried about the number of berries we're finding. It's almost like there might be a boss coming up soon. Oh, fuck. Oh, no! This is bullying. Goodbye, Muck.
Yeah. By the way, if you use Zen Headbutt against Muck, you'll be doing super effective damage.
Okay.
Yo, Metang, I love this funny little dude.
I love killing it. Jackie, the question you just set in Discord Friday.
Oh, right, your different time zone.
Yeah. Yeah, for Jackie, it will be midnight Friday.
What's the spell?
Tears of the Kingdom.
Yeah. I'm gonna wait.
You said Zen Headbutt, right? For Muck?
Yeah, it, because Muck psychic beats poison.
I have too many games that I still need to play that I already own.
Yeah.
Oh god. Tangela, you need to get a haircut.
Hell, I never finished Breath of the Wild.
That's Tangrowth.
Yeah, that's what happens when Tangela doesn't get a haircut. I'm gonna be honest, I was completely uninterested in Tears of the Kingdom until the last trailer.
Well, you saw Legend of Zelda Nuts and Bolts.
No, even when we learned about Nuts and Bolts, I still wasn't that interested. It was the story trailer that got me.
Yeah.
Ah!
I think you're calling in the wrong chat, Jackie.
Yeah, that's the wrong chat, I think. Hey! There's Grovyle! You two. Grovyle, are you alright? Stay back! What? Why? Careful, an enemy lurks nearby. What? Where? It's right beside you. Next to me? It can't be this. What? Evil Rock. Hee 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 hee. All those who trespass upon this land, none shall be forgiven. None. Not least of all you. Who's that? Who are you? You ask that of us? Our name is Spiritomb. We are the manifestation of a fusion of spirits. 108 of them. Yeah. Be careful, you two. That Pokemon is strong. Hee 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 hee. Prepare to take your punishment. I can't believe we have a shitty... you know what? No, I'm not going to make that joke because that's not even remotely fair. Okay, let's see. Boss time.
Yeah, as someone who knows exactly what you're going to say.
Yeah, that's not even remotely fair.
It's not exactly what is happening here.
Yeah, it's not even remotely fair. Ominous Wind. All right, you know what? I'm going to move up.
Oh, God.
This is bad. Okay, hold on, I have two Reviver Seeds. I have several seeds. What seed can I make use?
Eat a Blast Seed on yourself. Don't use it on me, because I will
waste it.
Oh, go into Tactics and have me switch to attack enemies.
I'm trying to see, do I have any particular type of seed that might work? I've got a sleep seed. I'm gonna use the sleep seed. Now I'm gonna use the blasting seed. I'm gonna blast it. I love that it goes into the little pebble.
Into the keystone?
The pebble.
Okay. You're right.
What move would be... Oh, I should use an orange berry.
Make me stop using... go into... For me, make me stop using anything but Volt Tackle. For you, Feint Attack is your only move that this thing isn't... doesn't have... isn't super resistant to.
What was that?
Feint Attack for you.
Feint Attack.
Or Shockwave, technically, but don't use Fake Out or...
Alright. 128, my goodness. Oh, you're in trouble. You're in dead. You have a revive seed.
Yeah.
And Spiritomb's gone. Whoa, what's happening? Eep. Eep. Run away.
Eep.
What was that? What was all that about?
I think that animation is incredibly funny.
It
runs away by the keystone.
Yeah, it just bounces.
Because in every other time Spiritomb has been depicted, like in, I think, Legends Arceus, it's like following you animation. It doesn't. Like, it's held in place by the keystone, and like it just sort of like nudges in your general direction. And then teleports closer to you once you get too far away from it, and then because it can't move. And I think, like,
that's great.
It's incredibly funny. I love Spiritomb.
They got spooked and ran. Grovyle! Are you alright? Yeah, I'll be fine. Can you get up? Somehow. Ugh. That Pokemon, it was cunning. It went up my nose and took control of my body. So that was a bad Pokemon. No, that's not true. That Spiritomb was probably upset over us trespassing in its space. You really need to get over this, liberal concept of good and bad. It's a lot more nuanced than that.
You're joking, but yes.
It was frightening because it became so angry that it lost control of itself. But you saw what happened when the situation turned sour. It fled. It's trying to, you know, just stay alive in this very fucked up world. It's normally a timid Pokemon. There are many such Pokemon here in your future. They are Pokemon who should be good, but they have become bitter and twisted because of this world's perpetual darkness. I see. Good Pokemon going bad because of this world. Are you not listening? That makes me sad.
Children's game moment.
Grovyle's trying so hard to explain that good and bad are just, like, manifestations of the context you find yourself in, and your partner Pokemon's just like, oh, so bad Pokemon are still bad, it's just sad. Hey, you two. Now you finally trust me. Somewhat? I'll admit it, I don't really trust you, but... I've told you before, there's no point in continuing together if there's no trust between us.
Yes. What Whisker Biscuit said in chat. This game has made Grovyle a lot of has drastically increased people's perception of Grovyle, and because Grovyle is incredibly based.
Grovyle is very based, from what I can tell.
Yeah, it's very funny.
I'm in pain for saying that. I hate that word.
You're right, I'm sorry. Yeah, base.
I'm leaving. You keep saying base and I hate that word. Oh, wait! I didn't say I don't believe you. To be perfectly honest, we don't know what's what anymore. That's why we want to know as much as we can learn. And it's true I still don't completely trust you, Grovyle, but what you said does make some sense. It just seems to be logical. So please, Grovyle, please tell us what you know. Please tell us about this future. And why you came to our world, Grovyle? So, what if everything I say is a pack of lies? A six-pack of lies? It's alright. I won't accept everything you say at face value right away. I'll listen, then decide.
It's alright, smile.
Well, fine. Follow me. Okay, hold on. What are we reacting to? I was reading and not processing fully. I was like 90% processing.
About what? What?
The oh my god and apartment complex joke.
Apartment complex was in response to Tactician Geek saying based on what?
Oh.
I'm not entirely certain what oh my god was in response to.
Probably the same thing.
I think Grovyle is probably more acidic.
Oh my god.
Good. This will do. Though Sableye won't be able to spot us easily here. Tell us, Grovyle, in the future, why did the planet's paralysis take place? The cause of the planet's paralysis? That dates back to your time in the world of the past. The planet's paralysis started with the collapse of Temporal Tower, which was governed by Dialga. Dialga? Who is that? He's a legendary Pokemon that controls time. Dialga ensured the proper flow of time from Temporal Tower. But when the Temporal Tower collapsed, time gradually got out of control, and eventually the planet fell into paralysis. What happened to Dialga? When time went out of whack, Dialga also lost control. Now, here in your future, the planet has become fully paralyzed. And thus, Dialga has lost almost all his reason, and is governed by darkness. Dialga is now beyond recognition. He has become an entirely different entity. Yes, he has been transformed into Primal Dialga, a primordial presence. And yeah, the existence of Primal Dialga is one of the things I remembered from like 10 years ago. I'm a little sad, but also like, it makes perfect sense. Okay, Primal Dialga feels no emotion. He seeks only self-preservation so he prevents history from changing. That's why Dialga wants me gone. It's because I try to change history. Because I try to stop the planet's paralysis. Because I traveled back in time to your world from this place, your future. What? Grovyle, you're saying that you came back to our world so you can prevent the planet's paralysis? But that's completely the opposite of what we were told. Grovyle, Yeah, you're figuring it out finally, please. Have you considered that you were lied to? Grovyle, you came back to our world to paralyze the planet, didn't you? And Grovyle, weren't you the one stealing the time gears? You've got to be joking. I was collecting time gears because they were needed for preventing the planet's paralysis. I needed to take them to Temporal Tower and put them in place. That would have reversed the collapse of Temporal Tower, which was fully underway in your time. While it is true that removing a time gear from a specific place causes time to stop in that area, that's only temporary. After the time gears are put into Temporal Tower, time would have been fully restored to normal everywhere. But then what about all the things Dusknoir said about you? He was lying! Like how he said you are a wanted outlaw in the future. Not necessarily incorrect! Like, if Dialga rules everything and wants to prevent good things from happening, then yes, heroes would be villains!
Anyway, punch a superhero.
And how you escaped from the future and then fled to our world in the past, so you're claiming all that was just a bunch of lies? What else could it be? Because Dusknoir really is an agent sent from this future by Primal Dialga to get rid of me. What? Dusknoir was an agent sent to get rid of you?
My god.
That's what I just said! Okay.
That's not even, like, even if everything Dusknoir said was true, that was true.
Oh my
like,
god.
Dusknoir said as much himself.
All I can think with Dakaril repeating everything is just Metal Gear.
Yeah, I was about to say. So Metal Gearing is apparently, I have been told, correct me if anyone knows better and I'm wrong. What I have been told is apparently that's just a common writing style in Japanese to like be repetitive with some information.
And that's what I've heard too.
And if that gets directly translated like it does in Metal Gear and like it's happening here, it does not come across well in English because that's not what we like to see in English.
Yeah, I don't know if that's true or not, but like I can very much say it feeling annoying is very much the case.
Yeah. Dusknoir was an agent sent to get rid of you? That thing you just said? That's right, that is what I just said. I have said that Primal Dialga will try to thwart any attempt to alter the course of history. That's why when he learned that I traveled through time, he sent Dusknoir after me. The great Dusknoir? Stop calling him great! It can't be. It's hard for you to believe, I know. I can't believe it at all. You're saying that all this is about the great Dusknoir. I don't understand why Dusknoir is acting this way here, but... but I respected... Stop hero worshipping! It's not healthy! I respect it, Dusknoir. I can't believe you. It is hard to accept, but... looking back over what we've been through in this future world... what Grovyle said is reasonable. It makes perfect sense, and Dakaril knows it. Thakurioff knows deep down that what Grovel says is true, but knowing that makes it that much harder to accept. But... hey, where are you going? I'm going to see Dust- No! 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 Do not!
Into your heart, you know it to be true.
Thakurioff, I'm so sorry I named the partner after you.
No, it's fine. Like, when the partner isn't doing this specific thing in this specific part of the game, they're really good. It's fine.
I feel so bad. I'm going to see the villain. What? I want to see Dust Noir. I'm going to find out if what you said is true or not, and then I'm going to become a villain. What's the point of that? You'll only be making it easy for them to get rid of you. You don't stand a chance against them. Then, what am I supposed to do? What are you supposed to do? Didn't you wonder this earlier? And you decided that you would decide for yourself. You insisted that because you don't know what to believe, you wouldn't accept words for their face value. Thank you for literally calling them out! Oh my god!
Yeah.
Grovel, the reasonable parent dealing with two children.
Not even... I don't know if I would call Dusknor a parent. Dusknor is like...
Grovel.
Grovel is like the older brother.
The older brother who's sick of this shit.
Who has to babysit the younger children.
It's like that one meme of the one person with the two others on child leashes, but it's Grovel with Skitty and
Shanks.
Luxret and Shanks, yeah.
Yeah.
It's not even Skitty though. It's only the partner who's doing this.
You said you wanted to accept words for their face value, and you'd think for yourself! But now that's too hard, so you're gonna go back to the propaganda that tells you about good and evil. Cough, cough, political commentary, social commentary, cough. It's times like this when things are tough that you have to be strong. Think for yourself, then act as you deem right. Grovel, what are you going to do now? I'm going back to the past again to stop the planet's paralysis. To do that, I need to find Celebi. Celebi? That's right. You can come with me or not, it's your choice. You two decide on your own course of action. I'm off.
So Celebi's gonna take us back to the past.
We're gonna go reenact Pokemon Forever. I watched that movie on so many times as a kid. I'm pretty sure I broke the VHS from how many times I watched it.
I only ever saw the first Pokemon movie.
I don't know what I should believe either, but there is one thing I can say with certainty. In this future world of darkness, the planet is paralyzed. We just need to use, what's the berry that undoes paralysis?
Cherry.
We just need to use a massive cherry scarf. That'll fix everything. And the paralysis of the planet, it happened back in our world. That's why to stop that from happening, we have to get back to the past. We have to get back to our world. I'm trying not to do the AVGN thing. Thank you for doing it for me, Foxy. Violet, yes, I know. What Grovel said, Grovel's right. Things are very tough now. That's why we have to be strong. I'm all right now. Let's go. Let's catch up to Grovel. Violet.
At least they got over it quickly.
Yeah, okay. The fact that it is only a momentary temporary thing, I can understand it as like a panic attack, like, holy shit, there is a lot happening. Everything I know is a lie. I understand that, but it's also like, please process a little bit faster. We have to get back to our own world. How many times have we said that exact sentence?
I don't know how many times you said it, but I feel like you're going to need to say it a few hundred more times.
Master Dialga, the stage has been set for the capture of the traitors. When the time comes, it may be necessary for us to beg your help, Master Dialga. As you wish. By your leave, we shall proceed.
So I'll be honest, I was expecting Dusknoir to turn out to be not a good person, but I wasn't expecting the evil future minion thing. I was thinking they were just going to be like a Captain Quark.
Mm. What? What was that strange sensation? I've had that strange sensation before. Where are we? This is Dusk Forest. Its name comes from the dark fog that perpetually shrouds it. Oh god, stay away from the fog. There will be an explosion if we stay in it too long. Deep in this forest, we should find Celebi. Hey, Grovyle, you mentioned the name before, but who's Celebi? Celebi is a legendary time travel Pokemon. She has the ability to cross time. But, well, she's a little odd. But anyway, Celebi's ability enabled me to go to the past. So if you find Celebi, can we return to our world? Yes, you can go back. But Celebi is the Pokemon that sent me to the past. That means Celebi has lent her support to reshaping history. Wait, are you saying that Celebi's in trouble too? That's right. Primal Dialga is also targeting Celebi. So there's no time to waste. And yeah, Foxy, I completely agree. I think it is a fairly realistic response. It's just also like, please, things are a little bit too desperate right now to, like, be having emotions. We can process later.
I mean, also, the main characters I'm pretty sure are supposed to be children.
Yeah, kind of feels like it. So there's no time to waste. Get ready soon. We have to find Celebi.
But also, like, they're very much, like, I don't know. I feel like this is a kind of thing that, like, saying it will get some weird teenager mad at me, but, like, the partner and the player are definitely, like, a couple. Like...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there is, like... There's a lot of queer coding between them. Like I was joking earlier, they were roommates.
Yeah, also, like, speaking of that specifically, The other change that I made to the game was making it so that the partner Shinx wouldn't be male.
Yeah.
For obvious reasons.
Oh, you know what? I'll take the Plainsy as well. I'll find an excuse to use that quickly.
No boys allowed. Boys are gross.
Well, I guess you gotta leave the voice chat then.
Rip.
I'm kidding. If we don't hurry, the Sableye will catch up to us. We're leaving as soon as you're ready. Well, I'm ready. Okay, let me save real quick, actually. That is a good point. And... we've got 30-ish minutes before the next ads want to run. Yeah, let's go. Let's do it. You seem to finally be prepared. Let's go then. We'll find Celebi and return to the past. Let's go. Next time we hit like a rest point, I'm assuming there's a rest point in this upcoming dungeon, I'll run some ads just to calm Twitch. Oh wait, don't go. What is it? If the three of us do return to our world, Grovyle, will you steal the time gears like you did before? Borrow them! We went over this! We're relocating them to a place where they're more practically useful! Well, yes, I will. Otherwise, the planet's paralysis can't be stopped. But I'm not convinced yet, Grovyle. I don't completely trust you yet. I'm only cooperating with you because I want to return to our world. If we do return, I'll investigate if you really were stealing those time gears to prevent the planet's paralysis. Grovyle, if I decide that you're wrong for stealing the time gears, I'm gonna stop you. Well, you know what? At least you're not immediately assuming that stealing is wrong. Huh, do as you will, but keep this in mind. What's important now is getting ourselves safely back to your world. So for the time being, focus on getting back home. Let's go. I feel it. I'm sensing something strange.
God, soul.
I feel the cosmos. What's the matter, Violet? I just know it. I felt something like this before. It was... That's it! It was when... What's wrong? Okay, I'm 99% confident I know exactly what our character's backstory is. What's this weird sensation? I don't know why I'm feeling this way. Wait a second, I know this place. Alright, yep, I definitely know our character's backstory.
You should. What do you mean?
I will explain in DMs later. I thought so.
But you know because
Twitch spoiled me. I know because Twitch spoiled me.
But you forgot. How do you know what the backstory is?
I thought so. This is similar to the sensation I had back then. Hey, what are you doing? Hurry! We have to hurry, Violet. Oh no! Wah-heh-heh. All right, well, we're gonna have a nasty boss fight coming up. Yay, Grovyle's in the party. All right, I assume we're still focused on getting the fuck out.
Yeah, I would say more than not. Oh, also, I'm still only using Volt Tackle.
Good point.
Undo that until we're in a boss fight again.
I also need to change your tactics back to let's go together.
Yeah. Massively. Massively important.
Garchomp. No, Gabite. Gabite. Miss Magius. Kind of a cute Pokemon.
I like Miss Magius. It's great.
So many logs. Are we going to see Professor Oak in here? That is a terrible trap! No! Oh, Grovyle is very high level. Oh, my.
Yeah.
Does that mean I'm underleveled, or is Grovyle just that strong?
Grovyle is really high level. Well, not really high level, but Grovyle is high level.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I'm out. Okay. And let's see. Next up's going to be Iron Thorn. Don't slow me down. That's rude. Only rude people slow me down. I just got a DM from Fur. Curious what I've been sent. I hate poison! Okay, good. Exit. Oh my fuck! I'll send it to you later. Actually,
what's happening?
I'll send it to you later. I think it is technically Future Redeem spoilers.
Oh, okay.
But, like, you in particular will want to see it once you've played Future Redeemed.
Gotcha.
Is it something I would get?
No.
Okay.
It's, Future Redeemed and Final Fantasy XIV.
Okay.
Oh, I'm excited to see what you have to send me. Reviver Seed! Hell yeah! Oh, well, that's polite. And the forest has changed. And, okay. Should be good. Give me those iron thorns.
Iron thorns? But they're not in this game. This is a Gen 4 game.
Brick break.
Yeah, I don't think either party member can learn it, but it's a good move.
Okay. Power band.
Why are you banning power?
Banned.
I know. He's joke.
I know. I just don't like jokes. Jokes are mean. How dare people Man. Have fun?
Man, what a bunch of jokers.
Yeah, Ryan's right. Everyone is such bullies. Alright, your turn, Grovyle. Oh, I'm constricted. Oh, dear.
Oh, yeah, Sandtomb doesn't let you... you're trapped in place.
Alright, well, I survived. You deal with it. And you're poisoned. And I leveled up! Okay, let's keep moving. I said this earlier in the stream, but I do really like how each dungeon has its own, like, specific character on how the RNG works for setting up the floors.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Yeah, it's subtle. It's always really... It's always subtle unless you look at very specifically at the map. Slumber Orb.
Was a rock supposed to put you to sleep?
Well, I guess really boring.
Oh my god, this is getting close. I think I might have to give you an Oran Berry unless we find the exit lake. It's in the bottom right. No! This is bad.
Yeah, just heal first.
Yeah, there's the exit. I'm just gonna move to the exit. Yeah, this part of the game is hard.
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah, this is a similar story. This is a similar kind of like gameplay story arc to something similar in Blue Rescue Team. And that point in Blue Rescue Team is when I gave up on the game in middle school. So if I can make it past this, then I am a better gamer than I was in middle school 10 plus years ago.
I mean, I think you probably
well more
are.
Than 10 years ago, 15 years ago. Ooh, blessed. What were you saying?
That's a good question. I'm thinking about it, and I realize I don't really I don't know.
You started, I think you, or I think you're.
Oh, I think you probably are a better gamer.
Nah.
You're probably right.
I'm clearly terrible at the video games. I misread Mothim as Mothman. I killed Mothman.
I mean, Mothim is 100% male, so like...
Mothman! And you hit level 34! Hello, Miss... Oh, Road!
Oh god, it takes all your PP in this game?
Yeah! At least now I don't gotta get my bottom surgery. And I don't need to use the car door either!
Oh god, please stop using Volt Tackle on the ground type.
For a second I thought you were reacting to the fucking car door joke.
I wouldn't know. I think I'm pretty good at responding to your jokes with just acceptance.
Okay, wait, do you remember the car door joke? Because that was not my joke. That was a big meme on Twitter, like, last year.
The Daffy Duck?
No!
No.
It was on trans Twitter. Someone shut the door, shut the car door on themselves and was like, I guess I don't need bottom surgery anymore.
Oh, I was thinking of, I slammed my penis in the car door.
Slammed your penis in the car door.
Yeah, that was basically the joke, but it wasn't Daffy Duck.
Well, yeah, like that.
And Parappa the Rapper.
Yeah.
Is this where Celebi's supposed to be? That's right, it was around here that I met her the last time. But if Primal Dialga knows of this place, Celebi will have fled from here. If this place isn't known to our pursuers, however, then Celebi should still be here. Yeah, no, it wasn't that. It was not that video.
Okay, well, this was a big... This was more than a year ago. This was like 2 years ago, but...
Hello, Celebi? It's me, Grovyle. Reveal yourself if you're here. She's not coming out. Did she get frightened off by Primal Dialga? What if she's been captured by Primal Dialga? Captured? Wow, where'd that voice come from? But now, I don't hear anything. That voice, was I just hearing things? Teehee, you didn't imagine it. Me? Captured? How insulting. Captured? Impossible, that's for sure, hehe. Yo, Celebi's shiny!
Yeah.
It's been too long, my dear Grovyle. Yes, it has been a while, Celebi. What? This tiny thing is Celebi? Please, do not insult Celebi. She will not bring us back in time if you do that. Now that is downright rude. How inappropriate to poke fun at my petite proportions. I'm sorry. I heard you have the ability to cross time. So I expected you to be some awe-inspiring Whoa, shut up, please! How uncouth! Never judge someone by appearance! You kept saying all these Pokemon look bad, and now you're calling me small! But I forgive you. After all, you must find me cuter and more special than you imagined. Hee hee! Yes. Celebi, I need your help again. I know. Seeing you back here, my dear Grovyle, tells me everything I need to know. You're back because you failed in your mission in the past, yes? Why would I send a failure back to the past again? Please don't actually let that happen. Yes, it's true. I hope you manage this time. I've quite had enough of this. Living in this dark and dreary world is so depressing. Sorry, no time to chat. The Sableye are tracking us. If we don't leave soon, we'll have brought trouble to you. Hee hee. There's no need to be worried. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Soul Foxy, and thank you for the follow. It was very good to have you here. It's quite fine. There's no need to be worried. Let those Sableye come. They're of no concern to me. Besides, if you'd be so kind as to prevent the planet's paralysis, we'll finally be spared the agony of this world of darkness. My dear Grovyle, I'll devote my whole life to achieve that end. All right. Where's the passage of time? Not the passage of fate? It's ready. It's nearby. The passage of time is on a plateau above this forest. That's good. Can you guide us? Yes. Are all three of you taking the passage of time? Yeah, that's right. Oh, what's this? Your friend. What? What? No, that can't be. Is something the matter, Celebi? No, it's nothing. Well then, shall we? Off to the passage of time. I was right. Hey, Grovyle, so what's the passage of fate? The passage of fate is a portal that Celebi uses to travel through time. It's a secret corridor that spans dimensions. For short trips, I can travel through time all by myself. But for big trips that span many generations, I must use the passage of time. Oh, so if we were to go through that passage of time, yes, you'll be able to return to your time. Oh, I see it. There's the entrance that leads up to the plateau. The passage of time is way up there. Good. We'll leave as soon as we're ready. Alright, I'm gonna run ads real quick just to calm Twitch down. We'll run 2 minutes while we get items ready. Alright, let's get prepared. Check the storage. Store. What do we want? Extra power band can go in there. Box can go in there. Brick break. Don't need 3 reviver seeds, I think. I have heal seeds. I need to make use of my items! My god! And I don't think I need that many apples. Okay. I think that'll actually be fine. Let's save. And then we'll take a minute to wait for the ads to finish up. I assume this is going to be the last dungeon, maybe with a rest spot in the middle, and then we head back to our time. Maybe with a boss at the end of it.
Yeah, I think that's...
Okay.
I think that's right.
Your title suggestion was perfect, and I did realize later that day that this is probably exactly what you meant, so I ended up not using it for that reason.
Was Frisker Biscuit's title suggestion?
I think it was The Future Awaits.
Oh, gotcha, yeah.
I wasn't sure exactly. I had 2 other ideas of what it could mean, but then I realized, oh, we're probably going to the future. But yeah, when I realized what it probably meant, I was like, it's a good title, but maybe a little too on the nose. So I went with Dusk Noir and Grovyle because it's the conclusion of their arc-ish, kind of. Not really. Okay. Ads are about done, so let's get moving. On to the next dungeon! Are you all ready? Let's do it. Good. We're leaving. We must make our way to the Passage of Fate. Let's go. God, thank you! Thank you for the Drake and Josh meme. Oh, that's fantastic. I really wish I had a setup to show memes and images like this on stream. It's Drake and Josh trapped inside the treehouse, if you've seen that meme. But green screen to be in the prison. This is the worst birthday party ever. Why? Because Dusk Noir betrayed us? No, because it's a little human. Yes, because Dusk Noir betrayed us! God, that's a good meme. Alright, let's get moving. Violent seed. Now we can be really violent. Hi, Rhydon! It cringed! I'm cringe! Hooray! I love being cringe. It means I have power over my enemies.
Do not kill the part of you that is cringe. Kill the part of you that cringes.
Indeed. Oh, we have Celebi in the party too! I just noticed. Nice. I love that it's a shiny Celebi too. That's so good.
Yeah, it's very cute. Oh, you can switch back to having a move with more PP as yours.
Oh, true. Exactly. Petrify, orange berry.
Orange.
Oh, Grovyle ditched. Bye, Grovyle. 114!
Yeah.
Okay, so the heal seed would heal like poison, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'll save it for something like that. I'm going to try to be better about using items, but watch as I then not do that. Does my health bar actually go off the screen now? Or is... it looks like it's getting close, if not already.
No, I think that, like, I think that's the max size, and then, the, like, how much each.
Okay. Okay, that thing. Makes sense. That makes sense. The only good isekai is Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. Who are the waifus? Grovyle. Valid.
What about Bidoof?
Yeah, Bidoof is also a waifu, and the partner Pokemon is, except when they're being kind of dumb. Also, hi, Leafeon. We got another meme. Dusknoir, as I'm assuming that's supposed to be Eggman? I'm assuming?
Yeah, that's the yes, your shittiness.
Okay. I want that Grovyle, you're all dead.
Yes, your rottenness. Yes, your shittiness. Right away, your dicklessness. We're on it, shitlip.
God. Oh, I watched the second half of the, Snapcube team does the Murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. I watched the second half of that. Their reaction to the ending with the t-shirts was so good.
I still haven't seen all of that game. I just saw like the first two rooms.
It is a very good game for being just an April Fool's joke. And also it's just kind of a good game in its own right. I would have paid $5
but
for it.
I wish that about every Pokemon game. Or not Pokemon, Jesus.
Yeah, Blaze is a Pokemon now. Sonic is a Pokemon spinoff.
Go, big man. Steelix is like if Onix was good.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
So how exactly does a rock Pokemon turn into a metal Pokemon?
Literally a steel coat, I think.
Well, I mean, yes, but, like, I think the biological explanation is that, it evolves by eating, like, pure ore, like, pure metal ore. Let's see, its body has been compressed deep under the ground. Many small metal particles cover this Pokemon's body. Its composition change. Why is that in the Steelix Dex entry? Tempered underground through high pressure and heat, its body is harder than any metal. It is thought that its body transformed as a result of iron accumulating internally. The iron it ingested with the soil it swallowed transformed its body.
Okay. Leafeon! Perish.
I don't see any Paris here.
Perish.
You don't know Parrish song.
No, but I will when I get that far in the Bard quest line in Final Fantasy XIV. I guess I have gone that far in my main.
Are you saying that as a bard you learn the brown note?
You have an entire expansion of trying to find the brown note. Thank you, Sebily. Oh my god! I hate- No! You know what? You all just- Oh god. I don't like this at all.
You use a trap bust orb. I think you have one.
I think I used it earlier.
Okay.
Okay, we got out of that. Okay, can I grab... What is this? Pure Seed. It is a good item, but...
I wouldn't take it. Like, you've got one with you, and like...
Sandstorm. Holy shit, it's only 3:16 p.m. We've made a lot of progress.
Yeah. You don't really have to waste any time going through like the end of day cutscenes or anything, so like you do progress pretty fast.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hi.
That sideways hip out on Sprite is fucking hilarious.
General Skitty.
You're out of PP.
Yeah.
Zen Headbutt is probably your best option for Steelix, I think. Actually, this is Gen 4, so Steel's... Well, I think Fake Out might do a little... Because...
Fake Out worked pretty well. Oh wait, hang on, what's that? Money! Ooh, immediate exit. Alright, Twitch wants to run an ad in 1 minute, so let's just run that 1 minute ad right now, since we're at a cutscene. Not the best timing, but I'm working with what I got.
I was going to say, since you're bringing money from the future, does that mean that you're going to be causing inflation?
Oh, God. That actually has sound. Yeah, I think I am going to be causing inflation issues. All right, let's see what this meme is.
Who posted my news on Twitter.com?
Thank you. Oh, my God. It's Dustmar with, Sonic fan dub Eggman. Thank you, Alfred.
Yeah, Alfred himself sent in the clip.
Yeah, Alfred himself decided he wanted to voice act as Dustmar.
Yeah, anyway,
God, we're gonna have a big hit week.
Tact, how far, when you say then it...
Huh?
I could... Oh, Tactician said, Geek said, come on. Then... Yeah.
You are cutting out. Is your mic okay?
It looks like I nudged it into out of the way of where it's supposed to be.
Anyway, you were asking me something?
Yeah, you said Pokemon inflation has a different meaning than it used to, and I wanted to ask how long ago was that used to, because I'm pretty sure that has existed as long most of the internet's lifespan.
Hey, I don't go looking for it. I don't see it. It's gone to me.
I mean, I don't exactly go looking for it either, but
all right, we're moving on. We're moving on. Oh, I see it now. There it is. Now the question is, do we get a boss here? Is that the Passage of Fate? That's right. That's the Passage of Fate. I went through that Passage of Fate to go to the pass. Celebi, only you can open the Passage of Fate. Do your thing. Sure. Stop there. That will do. What? That voice. It can't be. Hello to you all. It's been a while. Dustmar. Your scurrying carried you far. But sad to say, that's all over now. It's all ogre now. The Sableye too. That's crafty, Dustmar. You allowed us to roam free, but you kept your eye on us the whole time. So you could capture Celebi as well as us. What? So you mean we were followed the whole time? Huh, I didn't see this coming. It's all my fault, Celebi. Oh? Apologies don't suit your style, my dear Grovyle. And do you honestly think that I can be caught? Hehe. Everyone, are you ready to fight? What? Of course! We're gonna power our way through. We'll push them aside, then dive into the passage of fate. Got it! Ha, so you'll resist? Spare yourself the effort. You have no chance of succeeding. We won't know for sure until we try. Dusknoir, you and me, now! Grovyle, are you really such a fool to think I'd come alone? What? Now, Master D- Oh no! Oh no! We're in trouble now! What? It turned pitch black!
Alright, final boss time.
But there's supposed to be 5 more chapters! What? That's... Grovyle, what is it? What is that? That's Primal Dialga. What? That's Primal Dialga. What's wrong, Grovyle? Where's your bravado now? Gah, my dear Grovyle. This is it for us. What? Why? Aren't we gonna fight? It's hopeless. Dusknoir on his own is one thing, but we don't stand a chance against Dialga. You two have kept up so well. I'm sorry to let you down. This is where it ends.
Yeah, we didn't get Riolu you didn't pick Riolu as a partner, so like,
if you have Riolu, you can beat Dialga?
I forget the exact, like, strategy, but I know that Riolu, you use Riolu in this run, and you can get, like, a really cheap with a combination of...
You keep cutting out real bad. I suspect...
God, what the fuck?
It's probably Discord noise filtering. Turn that off. Which will make background noise come through a bit more easily, but Discord noise filtering is really bad about cutting off people talking.
Is this better?
I mean, it sounds better so far. Haven't cut out yet, so...
Okay. What was I saying before this?
Riolu, there's a cheap strategy.
Oh yeah, I think Riolu is Riolu. I think Riolu gets Endeavor, which lowers the target's HP to be equal to your current HP. And so you can use that on Dialga, or maybe it's not Riolu that gets that. I forget, but you can use Endeavor on Dialga and then Riolu fighting type move. Because fighting type, Dialga can go down in like 2 turns.
Nice. But I surrender, Dusknoir. Do with me as you will. My dear Grovyle! What's the matter, Grovyle? It's not like you to give up so easily. Yes, I am giving up, but hope is still alive. Celebi, you remember? That last time, when I traveled back in time to prevent the plant's paralysis, I wasn't alone. I was right. There was another. What? Grovyle, you didn't come to our world alone? That's right. I had a partner. We headed to the past together. But when we were going through the passage of fate, we had trouble. We became separated. My partner should still be back in the- No, Grovyle, I'm so sorry. I am so fucking sorry. We have a problem. Even if I am eliminated, my partner will see our mission through to the end. My partner will prevent the planet's paralysis. I'm so mad Twitch spoiled this for me. Ha! What's so funny? Ha! So you claim someone went to the past with you, and Dusknoir knows our name too. Incidentally, what's the name of your partner? Go on, say the name. Why ask such a thing? Can't tell me? No, that's not true. My partner's name is Violet. Yep, there it is! I knew it! Yep. God damn it! Oh, this sucks! This is so bad! My best friend. What? What? Grovyle, did you say Violet? Well, this is Violet right here. What? You're Violet? No, it can't be. It isn't. The Violet I know isn't a Pokemon. The Violet that I know is a human. What? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, this sucks. Precisely. That's why fucking Dustmore smiled when he learned our name. Because yeah. he knew exactly what had happened.
Yeah, the funny thing is how the Dustmore smile.
That is a good question. Precisely. My good fellow Grovyle, that is unmistakably your friend Violet. And that's why you took us to the future. Fuck. God. Yeah. Oh, no! What? That Pokemon you see was once a human. What? Master Dialga had given me a mission. It was to get rid of you, Grovyle and Violet, because you fled to the past. I traveled through time in pursuit of you both. In the past, I gathered intelligence that might help me find you. And at one point, I met Team Gamers. I love that. That's our name.
I told you to name that.
I'm so glad. Hello there. You're from the guild, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, we're Team Gamers. We work at the guild. It's great to meet you. But at that point, I suspected nothing. My partner here just happened to see it in a dream. Excuse me? A dream, you say? By dream, what do you mean? When they mentioned the dimensional scream, I was skeptical at first. But then an idea began to take shape in my mind. And? Then we told you on the beach! Yes, with the memory of a name, and the memory of being a human before that. I beg your pardon? Human? So a former human with no memories, a human that possessed a dimensional scream, I became convinced then. You are... You said you know your name, at least. And that name would be... Oh, no! God! Ah, I see. Violet. Does that name mean anything to you? Yeah, it sure fucking does! No, it means nothing to me, unfortunately. A what? Did I just see the faintest... Did Dustmore just hide the faintest of smiles? Or did I imagine that? There was no doubt that this Violet was the very one that I had been seeking. So that Violet developed amnesia and was transformed into a Pokemon, which must be because of the accident during your time travel. Well, Violet's memory loss was a lucky stroke for me. After all, your partner failed to recognize who I am. It was quite easy to win over your partner's trust. And it was also easy to drag them to the future when the time came. Oh, we got another thing sent from Whisker Biscuit.
Yeah, more criminal.
I believe this is in the prison. Well,
no, that's the entrance to Wigglytuff's Guild.
Oh, entrance to Wigglytuff's Guild. Yeah, well, it's the start true of the game, you don't see remember, any Skitty Diglett, in these parts.
Doesn't identify your foot.
It's true you don't see any Skitty in these parts, but you don't seem to be bad. Arrow at Skitty, war criminal. It's fine.
It's fine.
Dustmore really was lying. Yeah, that is a thing that could happen. Lying. Which left you, Grovyle, the last part of the job to finish. I was a human from the future? And I was Grovyle's partner on a mission to prevent the planet's paralysis? And that's how I ended up in Dakarilf's world? Grovyle and Violet, with the both of you here, everything will end when we finally dispose of you. That will finally put an end to Grovyle's glimmer of hope. Everything ends for you. Ha 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 ha! It's Dustnoir, no! Dustnoir! Ha, have you finally come to terms with your fate? Grovyle! Violet! We shall be rid of you for all time. Oh god, what am I being sent now?
It's irrelevant.
It is completely irrelevant. It looks to be a JoJo.
It's someone on Twitter posted a dumb thing, and someone's making fun of them. Not like dumb, but just like kind of silly.
Silly, yeah. We shall be rid of you for all time. This is the end for you. Wah-ha-ha. Hey, Violet Grovile, you can't give up. God, you say not to give up, but what can we possibly do in this bleak situation? We have to think. I know. Celebi, can your time travel ability transport us to just a short distance to the passage of time? It will be easy with Dialga here. Dialga is a temporal Pokemon. It controls time itself. Even if I can make us travel in time, he'll have no trouble exposing it. It just has to work for an instant. Please. Attack! Wah-heh-heh. Time to travel. Time travel. Wah-heh? The vanished? Master Dialga!
Dialga yelling. Yeah, Dialga, he it king.
Ah! Our time traveling path has been shattered! There they are. We almost made it to the passage of time. Dive in now, you can make it! Now, into the passage of time! What about you, Celebi? Don't fret over me, I told you I can't be caught! Stop the planet's paralysis. Change history! Thanks. Thank you, Celebi. You're not getting away! Gah. I would like to save my adventure. Thank you. That's very polite.
I love the spinning animation that you do.
It's good. A new dawn. Passage. But that's not allowed. Time's broken. Oh, good news. I lost my memory again. This is... Alright, I'm gonna put forth a proposal right here. Polycule. Skinny Shanks and Grovile, let's do it. They were all roommates. What? Violet, where? Isn't this where I met you? It's like that beach. So that means, could it be? No, it is. We're in the past. We made it back to our world. Yes, we made it, Violet. But Grovile is dead. Hey, Grovile! Look, we made it home. Back to our world. So we did it. We made it through back to this world. Yes, this is where I met Violet. Let's see. I think it was right here. At this very grain of sand. This is where I found Violet out cold. Dead. So that's what happened. That trip through time sent me to the Eastern Forest. And that was the first time gear you took, wasn't it? And Violet and I both reached your world far away from each other. Oh, that's right. There's a lot I don't understand, like the whole concept of time travel. Would you please explain it to us? We definitely have time. But this isn't really the place to talk, so. Let's go to Wigglytuff's guild and talk there. Before we went to the future, we trained there in room there. It'll be the perfect place. We just got to explain that actually Dustnoir was the villain the whole time, and Grovile was trying to save the world by stealing time gears. That's going to be hard to explain. Okay, let's go to Wigglytuff's guild. We go there and Wigglytuff is Igglybuff. Too far! Hold on. Will I be well received if I go to the guild? We'll protect you. After all, I'm a wanted outlaw in this world. If I went to your guild, won't everyone be shocked? Don't you think they'd try to capture me? What, you're not into- sorry. Come to think of it, you're right. What to do? Oh, I know. There's a good place, but it'll involve going through Treasure Town. It shouldn't be a problem if we lie low and sneak through. Lead the way. Okay, it's this way. We're seriously not going to explain to the guild that Grovile's good, actually?
Ooh.
Wow, they really do give this at the worst time.
Remember, just kind of thinking about it. Do you think Chatot would listen to you?
Fair point. Oh my god, that rock. Is that a Sharpedo?
That's Sharpedo Bluff.
Oh, you're right. This cliff is known as Sharpedo Bluff. Sharpedo Bluff? Yes, it's where Sharpedo comes to bluff. I think the name comes from the fact that the cliff itself is shaped like a Pokemon named Sharpedo. As far as I can tell, nothing seems out of the ordinary. It's down here. I lived here before I joined the guild. And you never invited us to your home before?
Yeah, because you joined the guild immediately.
You could have at least invited me home. I thought we were roommates.
You were roommates. You lived at the guild.
Go ahead, go in. Well, thank you for the follow, Unstoppable 8000. I see. This is the hollow chamber in the face of the cliff. Phew. I'm glad no one's wrecked this place. That's proof for how little notice this place attracts. It may be better if we stay here for the time being. Agreed. And there was only one bed.
Rovell, I'm sleeping on the couch.
Damn it! But Violet, I never expected you to be that very same Violet. Grovel, can you tell us more about that? Yes, Violet and I, we were jointly investigating the planet's paralysis. A Pokemon and a human, paired together? Yeah, and Violet had, or has, a special ability like no other. We relied on that special ability to investigate the planet's paralysis. It played a vital part. Yeah, one of my friends, Whisker Biscuit, got that commission for me for my birthday a couple years back. It is great. I love it. At least assuming I'm using... Yeah, no, it is the right profile picture. By special ability, you mean the dimensional scream, don't you? Exactly, but the dimensional scream has a drawback. The dimensional scream requires the presence of a trusted Pokemon partner. Without that partner, the ability cannot be triggered. Ah, so that Zagreus is the trusted Pokemon partner. Canonically queer. Like, my god, they're almost saying it. A trusted partner. That's why we work together. The dimensional scream is set off by triggers tied to places where the time gears are hidden. We needed to find out where the time gears were in the past. We needed the dimensional scream to accomplish that. Wait a second. You said that there has to be a trusted partner nearby for the dimensional scream to work. But the dimensional scream was being triggered not long after we met. Your point? Doesn't that show how much you two trusted each other from the start? Would you put it like that? It's a little embarrassing. In addition, Violet developed amnesia. Upon meeting you, Dakarilf, your partner had someone to turn to. Perhaps Violet grew to trust you very quickly because of that. Oh, there's another thing I don't understand. Is the dimensional scream triggered in response to only time gears? Right. The opposite is also true. The dimensional scream is not triggered in places that aren't connected to time gears. Wait. Then what the fuck about the Meryl and Azuril? What the fuck about them then?
Yeah, that it's
Is that about to get explained? Are you about to bring that up?
I might.
Really?
I forget.
That's not how I remember it. Listen, Violet, do you remember that time we went off near Drowsy? And during our first exploration? And there were other times too. We went to places that seemed to have nothing to do with time gears. But even in places like that, the dimensional scream was triggered sometimes, wasn't it? Are you sure? But that never happened in the future. The dimensional scream was never triggered by places that had no time to time gears whatsoever. Well, if that's true, I don't know why it'd work differently here. Perhaps things are just different in this world. Perhaps the nature of the dimensional scream is altered in the past. So in the future, the dimensional scream doesn't work in places that have no connection to the time gears. Oh, that explains it. Maybe that's why that time with the waterfall, when we were in the future... Your dimensional scream. Use your dimensional scream. Touch the frozen water. Who knows, you may see something. Oh, I understand. That's true. It's worth a try. Touching the frozen water. It might give us clues as to about what's happening. We can't dawdle. Those Sableye will catch up to us. Well, let's do this quickly. Well, can you see anything? No, I'm not sensing anything. Maybe I couldn't envision anything that time we were in the future, because we were in a place that wasn't tied to any time gears. Maybe that's why my dimensional screen failed to work. Maybe Grovel is right about the future and the past being different. Or different enough to make my dimensional scream ability work differently. Anyway, like I was saying, we were investigating the planet's paralysis. We used the dimensional scream ability to identify the locations of the time gears in your world while we were in the future. That's it! Here! A time gear is here! I see. Place the drought stone in Groudon's heart. That lifts the fog. Very well done. Good job, partner. After identifying the locations where the time gears would be in the past, we took the passage of time. That brought us from our world in your future to this world. However... Whoa! Are you okay? No! Don't let go! Just a little longer. Come on, hang on! No, I can't! Hold on! What?! We encountered turbulence while we were traveling through time. Thus, Violet and I became separated. For some reason, Violet got amnesia and was turned into a Pokemon. I can only guess that it had something to do with our accident while traveling in time. I came from the future. And not just that, I came with a mission of preventing the planet's paralysis. I don't know, it seems so outlandish. It doesn't feel real somehow. Like this is all a video game. So, Violet, you may not remember any of this, but you were my closest friend. I worried about you when we were separated. I'm glad to see you're safe. Your appearance may have changed, and though you have lost your memory, you're still you. And none of this alters the fact that you remain my friend. Oh, Violet, I'm glad to see you again. Now, we have to decide on our course of action. Like I've told you before, I'm going to collect the time gears again. What are you going to do? I'm a little worried about how time stops in a region where its time gears are removed. But you're sure it'll only be temporary? That's right, as soon as the time gears are set in place at Temporal Tower, time will be restored to its normal state everywhere. Well then, we'll go too. We'll go with you, Grovel. Taking a time gear will badly affect the Pokemon that live in that area, but we have to prevent the planet's paralysis. Okay, then we'll go together. But the hour is late. We're also exhausted from all the running we've done. We should rest up tonight. We'll leave in the morning. So many save points so frequently.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff happening in here.
Yeah, that's fair. Oh, Ed, you are gone! Dakarilf isn't there. Maybe outside? I'm so mad there's three beds. What's the matter? Can't sleep? Yeah, just thinking. Thinking about Dusknoir? No, that's not it. Sure, finding out we were being deceived came as a real shock. But hearing your story earlier, Grovel, it really drove it home. What Dusknoir said in the future was really true. And it made me realize that Violet really did come from the future. I was mulling over things like that. Hey, look, Grovel! Sunlight! It's sunrise! Ah, yes, the downside of turning off noise suppression so you don't cut out all the time. Keyboard.
Sorry.
You are fine. I just want you to be aware. It's pretty, isn't it? Yes. Maybe it's because we were in the future for so long, but I didn't think that a sunrise could ever feel so renewing. The sun rises, then it sets. We take that for granted, and that's only natural. But things we take for granted, they're really the most essential things, and they're precious. All I'd ever known is the world future's world of darkness. Upon coming to this world and seeing the sun for the first time, it was staggering. Seeing it, it strengthened my resolve to turn history away from a future of darkness. After all, I'm a grass-type Pokemon. I rely on photosynthesis. It's pretty important that I have sunlight. There's one thing that I wanted to ask of you, Dakarilf. It's about that time in the future, when we were confronted by Dialga. Frankly, we were in a no-win situation. There was no hope. We shall be rid of you for all time. This is the end. For you. Wah-heh-heh. Hey, Violet Grovyle, you can't give up! You say not to give up? But what can we possibly do in this bleak situation? We have to think! But when all seemed lost, you refused to give up. Even I had given up. What compelled you? How did you manage to stay so strong? Well, I wonder too. I really don't know. But maybe it's because Violet stood by me. Violet? Take a look at this. This, what could it be? There's an odd pattern inscribed on it. Oh! Okay, I think I know what it is now. I've never seen anything like it.
DM me what you think it is. Also, I'm realizing that I'm probably going to be done here in a bit.
All right. Well, we've made really good progress, so we'll find a time to wrap up soon.
Yeah.
I've never seen anything like it. This pattern is new to me. This is my relic fragment. It's my personal treasure. I have this dream of one day solving the mystery behind this fragment. But I was such a coward, I couldn't work up the courage to go to the guild and apply as an apprentice. It was then that I met Violet. Violet? Well, okay, I'm putting my faith in you. Yes, I totally believe in you. You tell me to jump off a cliff, I'll do it. Yes, Violet was always there to cheer me up. And... bro, this is scary, but we need to be brave. And I need to face up to this. There's no giving up now. It all gave me courage. With Violet, I felt like I could overcome any challenge. That's how I came to feel over time. Maybe that's why I was able to keep going without giving up. Alright, I think I understand what you're saying. Yes, Violet has a special quality that makes others feel that way. The same way that I care for Violet as a friend, you, Dakarilf, also feel that same way about Violet. Okay, see, now they're just saying it's a polycule. Violet is lucky to be blessed with a friend like you. Well, it's morning. We should be leaving soon. Yes. Alright, it's agreed that we'll collect all the time gears. First, we have to decide which time gear we should target. Let's check the Wonder Map. From here, the Underground Lake would be the closest, I guess. How about Tree Shroud Forest? That was where I got my first time gear the last time. Where is that? Here. It's a little far from here, but there's no one like Uxie guarding that time gear. Oh great! If we were to fight someone over a time gear, that would attract attention. But that won't be a concern here, right? Exactly. That's it then. That's where we're going. Onward to Tree Shroud Forest. This is it. This is the entrance to Tree Shroud Forest. Oh? What is it, Grovyle? The atmosphere somehow feels different than last time. No, I must be imagining it. We'll go in when you're ready. Alright. I think, Dakarilf, you gotta leave soon, you said?
Yeah, and this is probably the best stopping point.
Yeah, I'm thinking the same thing. Let's go ahead and... I'm gonna put some stuff away. I guess just the extra Insomniscope. Then let's go ahead and wrap up for the day. We've made fantastic progress, I think. We went to the future, and then came back to the past. And now we are thieves. and the guild is going to feel betrayed by us, and that's going to be very funny. But yeah, thank you everyone for joining. Huh?
Did everybody betray me?
Indeed. But yeah, thank you everyone for joining. This has been very fun. We've made great progress, and we are now in what, chapter 15 or 16?
I think
it said 16. The point is, we're coming up.
But let me just make absolute.
Yeah. Point is, we're coming up on the end of the game, I think. It's 20 chapters, right?
Yes. Yeah, there's 20 chapters. You were in chapter 16.
Got it. All right, but yeah. No, this has been great. I cannot wait to get to the end. I don't know if I'll be able to stream this weekend because we're going to be hit with a massive heat wave. It's expected to hit over 90 degrees, and... So,
yeah, at work, they're having us take, like, some super heavy precautions. Like, we're going to be starting and ending really early on those days.
Yeah. Darn. So, yeah, we'll figure out when next we're going to stream more, but we are making good progress. Thank you, everyone, for joining, and I will see everyone next time we play more Explorers of the Sky.
Goodbye.
Bye.